Okay, I'm back. The game's back. Now we have them. I don't get it. I don't get it. I guess I'll go back up to higher. You don't really need a high bit rate for this game. Okay, so there you go. I wonder if they're messing with they've been messing with quality options lately, because I haven't been getting them. I was getting them every day, didn't even have to think about it. And now, the past few streams on my channel, sometimes I don't get them. But then I see people with, like, other people getting them. I don't understand. Whatever. I'll just have to pay attention to that from now on. It's okay. I don't mind. Okay, reset your stream. Refresh. Retrograde Tom is back online. Let's wait. Let's let people come back. I'm taking somebody else QOs. Yeah, but I feel like it would be nice if I could have them too, Joy. Because I know that's really important, because some people have slower internet, and it's really helpful if they can watch the stream on low and whatnot. Sorry. Okay, let's continue the game. We're going to continue the game. Let's go. That's a technicality. We'll deal with that at the appropriate time. Pay it no mind. So we're talking to a guy on the phone. He wants to date my Pia. He wants me to play a little game. All right, I accept the dare. I already feel your bike within my grasp. Smart boy, Doug. I'll send the package to you by courier as soon as I hang up. Bye. You replace the handset on the telephone and await delivery of the package from Edsel. 15 points. Now, I didn't get points when I ate the sandwich, which makes me think I screwed up. I can't beat the game. Should we restart the game? Hey, Sly Guy. You're enjoying the chuckle? I can chuckle all you want, Wobble. Hi, Izzy's. Guys, now we have to vote on something. Should I restart the game and get the mustard sandwich? I'm going to, because I'm really worried about that. I don't know if this game has dead ends. Okay, Xanth. I think Twitch must be working on their quality options system. Oh, 94. Oh, I thought it was 93. My bad. Thought this game was 93. I've been telling everyone it's 93, and it's 94. Already! The phone doesn't ring before I eat the sandwich. Okay, well, I'm a doofus. What else is new, huh? What else is new, huh? Hi, syllogism. Let's read that. Let's close the envelope. Let's back it up. Let's get out of here. Skedaddle. Turn on the lights. I thought it said the phone was ringing when I was back in the computer. Hi, Fellaheen. I said I would let people vote, but then I just restarted. I don't know if this has dead ends. If anyone knows this has dead ends, please tell me. I will love you forever, for my whole life. Take the phone. Answer the phone. Okay, it's not ringing. We need to go get the phone numbers off the post-it note and maybe call somebody. This is my computer. Am I an adult or am I a child? I'm a child, right? Whose computer is this? Read the post-it. Alright, you hear the phone, quiet ringing of the phone from the kitchen. So the phone's ringing now. Sandwich is useless? Okay, well I didn't know. I didn't know if I had to bring that into Xanth and give it to somebody and answer the phone. So, you don't have to eat the sandwich. Okay, who are you? What'd you say? Hi, Edsel. Things are pretty well. What's up? What kind of a bet did you have in mind? What's this game about? I can see where's this headed. What's the catch? What if I don't like the silly game? What if she doesn't want to go out on a date with you? I accept the dare. Hang up. I'm taking the sandwich. We can eat it later. Let's take the sandwich. Let's get the mustard. Maybe syllogism forgot. And you can actually do something with this sandwich, you know? Okay, let's squirt the mustard on the sandwich. Now we got a mustard, peanut butter, and jelly sandwich. Awesome. Now let's use the phone. I want to dial the weather. I want to dial the weather number. The outlook for today is thunderstorms accompanied by fierce winds. Humidity is 100%. Barometric pressure is 30. 442 and falling. That's the weather. We got the weather. Hi, Q. How are you? How's it going? Hi, Flying Minister. What's up? Let's dial Pia, and let's give her the what for. This is Pia's number. Hello, who is it? It's Doug Smith, Frank. Is Pia at home? She is at home, and she does not wish to speak with you now or ever. He slams down the phone and the line goes dead. Alright, call back. We gotta call back. We gotta harass them. Let's say, Domino's Pizza. That used to be a funny thing to do. When you didn't have... No, use the phone. Take the phone. When someone would call your number at your house, you would say Domino's Pizza, and they'd be like, did I have the right number? It's Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm your mighty pirate. Oh, this is the police. Come out with your hands up. Yeah. Not answering, Mr. Frank hangs up on you. Okay. I'm trying everything we can try here. Oh, right. He does ride a motorcycle. That's true. But then I live with my mom still, so I'm an adult living at home. That's okay. Har shouts Mr. Frank before he slams down the phone. Well, we got a little laugh out of him that time. Let's try the other solution. Doug Smith. Hi, Mr. Frank. Is Mrs. Frank available? So nothing works. Okay, let's try calling Ed. No, we don't need to call Ed back. Let's go back into the foyer. Got a sandwich. Look at this bracelet. Read the bracelet. I love P. Maybe we'll find someone named P in the other world. You open the front door and immediately feel the force of the storm building outside. Alright, let's take this package. We got the game. Let's open the package. Companions of Xanth. What if when I go into the game in this game, I go into the game in the real world? That would be cool. This colorful game package is closed and sealed with plastic. It's titled Companions of Xanth. Open it up. Whoa, there's a lot of crap in it. We got a game manual, a CD-ROM, a warranty card, a red book, and a pair of 3D glasses. Here's the CD. Can I just press L? Yeah. Okay, cool. The CD-ROM's a shiny disc with funny colors, okay? Plastic. It's a crumpled plastic wrap. It's kind of shiny. Look at the tome. You open the weighty Compendium of Xanth. This is how you learn about Xanth in this game. It tells you, in case you don't know, if you haven't read the books like me, it'll teach you certain things when you ask about these people. So, maybe we'll do that when we actually need to. Yeah, a bunch of plants in here. So there's plants. A lot of plants. There's creatures. Bum steer. The computer. Let's look at this. The computer. The most evil machine in Xanth, computer was created by the Muses of Parnassus to help in recording reality. The Muses erred in their design and the machine became malevolent, securing itself within an air-conditioned cave. Pewter can revise reality to its liking, and should therefore be avoided at all costs. Huh. So, the computer in Xanth is super evil. What else do we have? We had something that was said cumulonimbus like cloud zombies. They're half-animated corpses brought to life by magician Jonathan during the fourth wave. They make good servants, but because their brains rotted out, they can't perform any but the simplest of tasks. Nothing can hurt a zombie since they're already dead. It can only be killed by hacking it apart. P is for pizza. It does now. It used to be our girlfriend's name, Praxis, but she broke up with us. Is the snake lady Pia? I don't think so, no. I really don't. Because we're not in Xanth yet. We're in the real world. In this story, which is the 16th novel of Xanth, you get sucked into Xanth through a computer game. Which maybe I shouldn't have spoiled for myself. But I just wanted to read about the series, and I inadvertently read about what happens in the beginning of this game, which is you get sucked into Xanth. The way cool green and red tinted sunglasses are definitely the most interesting item in the game. Wear them. Alright, now we're wearing the 3D glasses. Cool. Alright, let's go to the computer. What is this? Wait, what are these pages? A card. Let's read the card. Look at the card. Look at the card. It's the most important thing in the game package. If you don't send it in, you'll never get all the wonderful support available from the game company. You used to have to register games like that. Is this real life? did I get 3D glasses? I don't have them in my box. It's the instruction manual for the game, along with a bunch of generally useless stuff. There's a number for free customer technical support. Can we go call that number? Let's look at this paper. It's the brown paper wrapping. Wow, we keep everything in this game. Let's go see if we can call that number. A simple task. Yeah, I want to leave the door open, Cusack. I want to let all the rain in and make my mom mad. That's my goal. I want that to happen. All right, let's call the technical support. The recording tells you that all calls are answered in the order they are received. Wait a little longer. All right, let's keep waiting. Okay, let's just click it a lot. Come on, you never know. Is Xanth related to Xene? No. No, they're not. Yeah, I guess it is. Pia's there to emphasize how much of a loser we are. We lost our girlfriend, and I think she just made up an excuse. She didn't actually... She just wanted to break up with us anyway. Oh well, give up and never call this number again. There was nothing there. We tried. That's all the amount I want to try. I don't want to try anymore. Okay. Hey, Ruka. Let's save the game. I don't know. I don't know if it has dead ends. No one has answered me. Home one. No one has answered me. Maybe nobody knows. That's fine. We'll figure it out. Okay, see. Wait, I don't have a CD-ROM drive. Oh, I do. It's down here. Okay. Let's turn on the computer first. Let's get into this game. Power switch. Let's, open the CD-ROM drive. Okay. Put the CD-ROM in the CD-ROM drive. Okay, close the CD-ROM drive. 9 points. Who is that? Who is that? Is that... Oh, you know who designed, Corey and Laurie Cole designed one of these Legend games. I forget if it was this or Shannara. I think it was Shannara. So never mind. Let's read the screen. He kind of looks like the Quest for Glory guy, is why I thought that. A strange male figure studies you expectantly. Tiny man. Poke the tiny man. You poke Grundy's tummy with your index finger. He doubles over in laughter and keeps giggling for some time. Okay, Grundy, huh? Let's see who Grundy is. In Xene, the Power Ranger Bugman was an alien, and Xene was made by aliens. The Power Ranger Bugman? It was all real, Dave. Famous people. Grundy. Grundy Golem. Grundy Golem, once made from bits of string, clay, and wood, began turning into an elf when he started to care. He was finally brought into living reality by the demon Xanth when he fulfilled a difficult challenge. Grundy's talent is to understand the language of all living things. Rude and tactless, Grundy gets in more than his share of trouble. I'm assuming there was a book all about Grundy, because that's how these series of books seem to go. They're all, like, focusing on one character. And each character has a special talent, like a special ability. So we're going to have a special ability, too. I don't know what it is, though. Let's poke him again. We're wearing these, right? Okay, let's give him this plastic. Oh no, I'm not a player in this game. Save your stuff for later on when I'm certain you'll need it. Okay, let's talk to this guy. Let's get to business here. Hi, I'm Grundy Golem. Welcome to the game. It's my job to answer any questions you may have about Xanth, the game, or your potential companions. What's a golem? A golem's an animated ball of cloth and twine a few inches tall. Huh, that's a different type of golem. Geez, sorry I asked. I don't believe you, I think you're a liar. I can tell you you're really not in the proper state of mind to appreciate the wonders of Xanth. Come back later if you really want to play the game. Oh, I thought it was going to make me quit the game. Oh, what the hell, man? Okay, calm down, man. Jeez, this guy really takes jokes personally. Holy crap. Yeah, this is one of the games, Joy, that I paid shipping to have shipped to me.
I already showed the box.
I already showed the box. It looks just like the thing above my head. Here's the back of the box. Look at that lady, jeez. I didn't even notice that. There's a sexy lady back here, and a sexy man. And a normal lady. Captain Worf? Oh, that's not Captain Worf. It's like a flame golem. I never even looked at the back of the box. Oh, looks cool. And there's a sexy lady there, for all you guys out there. Hey, Oni-chan. And hi, Braxton. A golem can be made of any material. That's true. You're right. I'm sorry. Braxton, I'm sorry. Did you wander into Kilgore's dream? You know, I was doing retro brags since Kilgore was in diapers, sit. On my channel, it's called the Retro Brag. It's not Box Hype. It's called Retro Brag. Look it up. Want to see who did retro brag first? I'm pretty sure it was me. Hi, Philly. Stop. All right. Okay, so if we piss him off, he's going to kick us out. All right, tell me about the companion thing. I can tell you about the game rules, the world of Xanth, or your potential companions. Tell me the rules of the game. You pick one of four companions from the land of Xanth to guide you through its hazards. Each one will try their hardest to assist you in your quest for a prize. Little is known about the prize, but once you've acquired it, you've won the game. Do you understand the rules so far? Okay. They guide us through the hazards. One will try their hardest to assist you. Each one will try their hardest to assist me. Little is known about the prize. So we're trying to get a prize. Hi, Jeremy. How's it going? Hi, the Grows. When will I stream B-17 Flying Fortress the Mighty Eighth? I don't know. I've never heard of that game before. Okay, tell me more about this intriguing game. There will be another mundane player like yourself on a similar quest within Xanth. Oh, we're called a mundane. She will also be struggling to acquire the prize and will also be accompanied by a companion. You may save at any time, but if you perish within the world of Xanth, you must begin the game again. I've got a pen now. So there's another mundane. Is it Pia? So I've got to kill this other person. Murder them viciously. If I perish, I have to begin again. Does this game have dead ends? What is B-17 Flying Fortress? Is that a flight game? I don't want to play a flight game. I don't like those anymore. I used to, but I don't. You can just call me Grundy if you prefer. Okay, try to actually play the game, Tom. Tell me about the strange world called Xanth. Xanth is a magical world distinct from the world you live in. We call your world Mundania, and few are allowed to cross between it and Xanth. Most creatures residing in Xanth possess a single magic talent that they can exercise at will. Some talents are relatively insignificant, while others are devastatingly powerful. Is this all making sense? Yes, it does. But there are other important things you must know about Xanth to win the game, Doug. Would you like to learn about them? Yes. A demonic presence is responsible for the nature of Xanth. Nearly all things in Xanth are magical in some way, and most things have names you would regard as puns. Take these punish names seriously, Doug, for they will be crucial in the success of your quest for the prize. Take the puns seriously. Take the puns seriously. Don't forget. Take the puns, take the names seriously. It's gonna be a solution to... Am I getting a display for the boxes? No. I'm not. It could be. I don't know who it is, Rethix. It could be my girlfriend. I don't know who my opponent is. Do you want me to tell you anything else? Yes. Tell me about the people you call companions. You'll select one of them. I already read this. Oh, here we go. We got Jenny Elf and her cat, Sammy. Jay Centaur, not a Naga. That's her. I bet you that's the lady above me. Not a Naga. And the demoness Metria. Oh, we can find out about them. Jenny Elf and Sammy Cat are a team and inseparable. Jenny has the unusual talent of being able to sing a song and see into people's dreams who are in her vicinity. Sammy possesses the talent of finding the quickest path to an objective, be it geographic or conceptual. He belongs to Jenny and pays more attention to her than any else. Okay, so let's write this down, guys. Jenny. I love you, Jenny. There you go. I went with it. I did the Forrest Gump reference that you all have been waiting for. Okay, so sing a song, seize dreams. Okay, and the cat, Sammy Cat, that's like two for one. Quickest path. Sammy Cat is the quickest path. Che Centaur, he's a Xanthian centaur. Centaurs, as you see, will have the head of a human and the body of a horse. Yes, I know what a centaur is. It gives them great speed and strength, coupled with exacting intelligence. Speed, strength, int. While many centaurs do not possess magical talents, Che does. He can make objects lighter, making them easier to move or carry. Objects lighter. Okay. I wonder if I even need to write this down. I probably don't. Hi, John Freeman. I used to like flight games, but I don't. I used to like Red Baron, and I played Blue Lightning on the Lynx, which I got that to work, by the way. I got my Lynx to work. But I don't play flight games anymore. Because I don't know of any like real good ones. And the old ones kind of don't hold up that much. I mean, other than X-Wing, of course. Nada Naga is a princess of Naga origin. Nagas are creatures with the head of a human and the body of a serpent. The particular princess possesses the talent of transforming herself into a completely human form, as you will see her depicted in the following screen. Although she has been inducted into the adult conspiracy, she will behave as if not for the duration of the game. Oh, really? Well, I don't have to write that down. I can remember that. Tell me about the demoness Metria. And the adult conspiracy, we should look at that first, because that's a unique aspect of the Xanth books. Ask Nada about that. It wouldn't be appropriate for me to discuss that topic with you. Okay? Tell me about demoness Metria. Demoness Metria is a female demon. Demons are unique creatures in Xanth, neither living or dead. She possesses a mastery of magic exceeding your other prospective companions, but she can also be quite dangerous. She derives much pleasure from pranks and magical mischief, and she has a reputation as a seductress. Although she's vowed to serve you well in the game, beware her cunning ways, so she's a betrayer. She has magic. Demoness Metria just has magic. We don't have to write that down. Magic and pranks. She's all about magic and pranks. Crimson Skies, that's true. Crimson Skies is cool. Also, Secret Weapons of the Luftwaffe, or what was it called? There was a newer one that's called Secret Something. Secret Weapons of the Something. It was a LucasArts game. It was like their last flight sim. Something like that. I'm done learning about companions now. Hey, what happened to all my stuff? Certain of your items can't make the transition between worlds, but can I take it I find here back home? I'm afraid not, Doug. The barrier works in both directions. Well, crap. What's the big red book for? I already know that. What am I supposed to do with the 3D glasses? Beats me. They're pretty cool, though. They don't look like ordinary glasses at all. Okay, I'm ready to pick now. No problem, Doug. I'm only doing my job. Pick well. I gotta pick. That's the Jenny. Jenny. That's Che. That's not a Naga. Oh, that's Demoness Metria. Ho, 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 ho. Who do you guys want me to pick? I don't know what the difference is. So, you guys want to give a suggestion on who we pick? You guys in the chat, feel free. This is Jenny. This is Che. This is the Naga girl who's over here on above me in human form. And this is the demoness. She's a prankster. We got to be careful with her. I don't know how this affects the game at all. I wonder if it makes certain puzzles easier. It was something like that. There was a new secret weapons, Jeremy. It was like secret somethings of the blah blah, but it was a newer one. Centaur, porn girl or Jenny. Okay, I gotta write this down. I gotta write down the votes. Okay, centaur. Rethix, I gotta give you a half vote for each, because you voted for two. So I gotta give you a half vote. That's a Jenny vote. Far left is a Jenny vote. Fantasy porn Jenny. Jenny, the little girl? You guys want the Jenny? Hit girl or devil girl? That's a half vote. Another half vote. Okay, so now that converts the halves into a whole vote. Or the demon. Oh no, I gotta take your whole vote and turn it back into a half. Okay. Yeah, okay. Demon Metroid, okay. Demon Metroid. Santa Park is Zelda. So the winner is Jenny. I don't really want to pick Jenny, though. I want to pick you, the one of these two. Thanks for voting. I think we should pick the Naga. She's got the ability to turn into a human. I don't know, maybe we pick Jenny. People voted for Jenny. Oh, there's another vote for Demon. Uh-oh, more votes are coming in for Demon now. Now Demon and Jenny are tied. And Demon Burrito voted for Demon. Alright, well, people voted for Demon. Sorry, guys. And then Braxton voted for Demon, too. So, I did pay attention to the votes. Thank you for voting. I noticed your double vote, Nimamska. Hi, Nimamska. That's worked on me before. You can't get me with a double vote. I'm too quick for the double votes now. Your dimly lit cavern. Metria stands beside you, getting her bearings. So now we've got Metria. I wonder if it's just you go into four different worlds. Talk to Metria. Kiss? It's not a good idea. She's probably gonna kill me. Let's save. Metria 2. Metria 2. We chose Metria. Kiss her. You kiss Metria deeply and embrace her passionately. She giggles and seems to enjoy it. She wraps her limbs around... Wait. She wraps her limbs around you and kisses you passionately. Her embrace... She killed me. She just killed me. She put me in a death embrace. Beware the wily ways of a wicked demoness, Doug. She'd like nothing more than to interfere with the game. She doesn't care whether you win or lose. I'm afraid you've lost the game. Okay, well, I saved the game. I'll try restoring. I had the presence of mind to save. I knew it. That wasn't going to be a good idea. Of course, she was going to kill me. Yeah, now that I write things down, you can't fool me anymore. You fool me once, you know, that thing. Fool me twice, you can't fool me again. Okay, let's talk to her. Chase her? Let's chase her now. You chase Metri around the dark cavern. After a few minutes, you tire of chasing her tail. Okay, talk to her. How about we just talk to her, like a normal person? I guess this is a game puzzle or something. Maybe we should try solving it. But how about giving me a kiss first, you beautiful mundane creature? So she's trying to trick... She's a trickster. Okay. Maybe it'll work out fine this time. We didn't finish Resident Evil 5. We're gonna play that again later this week. Oh, she killed me again. Okay, maybe... I thought maybe I wouldn't die. But I did. I died. I like how this game gives you undo. That's, pretty nice. That's pretty nice of them. When did King's Quest, what's the timeline on the King's Quest games? King's Quest games. That is a good death. If you gotta die, might as well be it like that. Do it like that. Oh, the King's Quest games are way older than this. By the time this came out, King's Quest 6 was already out. Okay. Good to know. King's Quest 6 was 92. Okay, how about giving me a kiss? Later, let's get out of this jam first. Not with that pointy thing waving around in the air. Hissing at you, Metria withdraws. I'm only doing this companion thing because I have to, mundane child. I'd hoped you'd been a bit more entertaining. Why didn't you just kill me? If you want to kill me, just kill me. Alright, what do we got here? Let's look at this door. The door has a metal knocker on it that is rusted to the door. This door looks like an oblong coffin mounted on the wall of the cavern. It's closed. Metria waves her hands at the rounded door in the middle of the cave. A moment later, a boulder falls from the ceiling onto both of you. All I did was look at the door. I didn't even open the door. As I advised you before, picking good companions is of utmost importance for you to succeed in your quest for the prize. You've lost. All I did was look at the door. But Metria looked like a great companion. Looks can be deceiving, Doug. I'm afraid you've lost the game. Okay, I'll undo the last move. So we can't even look at that door. Can I look at this door? This tiny door looks like it could be easily pushed open. Metria waves her hands at the rounded door in the middle of the cave. A moment later, a boulder falls... The same thing? I deliberately picked a bad companion just to see what happened. That's interesting. I hope you enjoyed it, Doug. Undo the last move. Do we just die no matter what? What if I look at this door? Wait, you... This door has a metal grating. Metria waves her hands at the rounded... So Metria is killing me. You just die no matter what? Hey, Paranoid. This is pretty really cool so far. I like this game. It's got a good sense of humor, just like the spellcasting games. Well, so we just can't pick Metria. We always lose. Is that why people told me to pick Jenny? Because they knew that I would not die? I think you're supposed to pick, this girl. If I look at this door, it's fine. Okay, push the door. Enter the door. She's always just waving her hands at the door and making us die. Start over. No, not at the beginning. Did we screw up? Do I have to restart the whole freaking game? That would be a little bit annoying. It wouldn't be that bad, though. Let's look at the torch. So I think it's like I can only do so many things. Can I talk to her? Let's grab her. She sticks her tongue out at you and you push away in disgust. Okay, don't move. Kenneth, what's the frequency? Don't hit me, she cries, covering her face with her pointy tail. What? I wasn't gonna hit you. She keeps opening this door and murdering me. I'm not even doing anything. I give, let me out of here. Oh, it's gonna quit the game. Crap, just quit the game. This game is super trolly right now. As far as I can tell, we can't pick this girl because she immediately goes to the door that murders both of us. So apparently this game does have dead ends. I guess that answers that question. When was the last... What's my last... Whoa, easy there, sound. When I mess with this, nothing happens. If I mess with this again, she's gonna kill us. Okay, it seems like I only have a certain number of moves and then she kills us. Alright, so let's, okay, let's see what happens if I open this door. We still die. Hey, you, Christensen. Yeah, this is totally trolling us. I mean, it's not that bad, Captain Shiro, with the choice, because we can quickly get back to this. We can quickly get back to the companion. Maybe this is like, if you are looking for a porn game, this ain't it. That's what they're telling you. This ain't gonna be porn. Fella. That's what they're telling you. Don't choose the hot demon. I just died again? I don't know what I did. But I also want to see if I can just get through this. If there's a way out of this. Okay, what else do we see around us? We just see bars and a door and a torch. And if I look above... Okay, what if I give... Okay, we're restarting. Okay, fine. So what are our choices here? I'll try restoring. I want to undo the last move. Start over. I screwed up too much. I give lettuce out of here. Quit. I'll try restoring home one. So I think I saved it right before we put the CD in the drive. We did. So we're right back here. We'll just put the CD in. We'll choose a different companion. I was wrong. I should have chosen Jenny, but maybe we should also choose Naga. Okay, everyone vote again. Everyone vote again for the other companion that we take. We're doing a re-vote. Now let's talk to this guy. Look at the screen. I'm not sure, Paranoid. I never read the 16th book. Yeah, she's totally useless. All she does is kill you. Beginning. It's trolling young, horny men that want the hot companion. Centaur, Jenny, Centaur, nerd child. Okay, now we'll actually listen to the vote. We're doing a re-vote. Centaur. Oh wait, Centaur. Centaur, Jenny. Centaur. Nerd child, Jenny. Home of restarts. Character that kills you. I can't pick her again. Dress girl. Okay, that's the third one. Everyone's picking Jenny now. Nerd girl. Dress girl. Nerd child. Wow, I wouldn't have thought everyone would go for the nerd child. I would have thought everyone would go for the Naga lady. Strangest standing male figure. You can't pick him. Pink girl. Well, right now Jenny's ahead. And we're gonna Naga, you pick the Naga. Alright, right now Naga has 3, Centaur has 3, Jenny has 5. I'm gonna give it a little more time, and then we're just gonna go with the nerd child. Everyone has named this the nerd child. Nerd child, she seems cool, and she's got a cool little cat, too. She can see into people's dreams. She's got a cat that can choose the quickest path. Alright, I like this, though. Oh, crap, we're in here. Yo, Jenny, don't fuck around, okay? The cat... Yo, guys, don't make shit fall, okay? Please. Luckily we have that awesome save right there, right before the choice, so we can come back and we can see what all the choices do here. Nerd child. Here, we'll call it nerd child too. Naga. Oh, Naga. And then Jenny. We got one Naga, but then we also got a Jenny. We got another Naga. Jenny's still winning. Sammy. Well, that's a double vote. Paranoid, you cannot get me with a double vote. Alright. So Jenny won. We've got the nerd child and her cat, which actually seemed like the best one. Let's talk to her. Wait a minute, Doug. I think this is a game challenge and we ought to be very careful. One of these doors is obviously the way out. What do you think, Sammy Cat?
Meow, meow.
Not very helpful. I need to learn the cat language. Meow, says Sammy, disinterested. Yeah, not interested in helping me get out of here, huh? Look at the door. Look at this door. The door has a metal knocker on it that is rusted to the door. Jenny asks Sammy to find the quickest route out of the cavern. She scratches at the leftmost door. A moment later, the door crashes down upon all three of you. What the hell? Yes, Earth Machine, this is based off the 16th novel, Demons Don't Dream. Hi, Voodoo Bebop. We just got killed again. The music's good. The music's actually pretty good. I like it. It's not repetitive either. It's not just like a 10-second loop. So, okay, maybe you can always get out. You just have to figure out what to do. What if I look at this door? I'm just killed. What the hell's going on with this game? You just always die unless you pick the right one. You probably have to pick the Naga. Sorry guys, Nerd Child is not going to be the one. Now we do Centaur. I agree with syllogism because I'm starting to understand what's going on here. You just will always die until you pick the right companion. That's what I'm thinking. So now let's do Centaur. Let's see what happens with the Centaur. And then we'll pick the correct one, which I think is the Naga. That's what I'm guessing is going on with this game right now. Because he told me to choose the Naga, and I didn't. I could be wrong. There could be a way to get through with the other companions, too. But I'm pretty sure you'll always die until you, that's what I'm guessing, until you choose the Naga. So now I'll save it here again, where we've, save it ahead again. Bam, 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 dun, dun, meow. Talk to the tiny man. I like the game, though. It's kind of weird, but... Alright. Okay, now we'll choose the Centaur. This is my knee. Alright. Snake lady. Yeah, it wasn't a boulder. We did get killed by a door. Hey, Ma. Ma, you right. May, you right. I don't think it's stupid. I think it's kind of fun. I'm not hating this right now. Talk to Che. But I could see why you would think it's stupid. This is clearly our first test. We better make the best of it. Give me a second to explore this cavern. Okay. I can wait. How you doing there, Che? Explore the cavern away. Let's look. The cavern you've appeared in is barely lit by a flickering torch hanging on the far wall. Four different doors lie upon the cavern wall. All the doors are securely shut. One contains a grate. Che rears up his hindquarters and punches through the third door, and you are killed.
Okay, I'm gonna restore and pick the snake.
Che Guevara. That's a guy, right? Okay, please, if I die with the snake too, I don't know how to play this game. Why do you keep capitalizing game and companion? If it's not the snake, I'm just gonna consider that the end of the game and play Deathgate. No, I'll try to figure it out. But I'm really looking forward to playing Deathgate, because that was one of my favorite games as a young man. And I read all the books. I have all the books. I can show you all the books if you want to see the books. We can book brag. Read the manual? I have the manual. You're in a dimly lit cavern. Okay, let's talk to Naga now. Not now, Doug. We're in grave danger. Give me a moment to get us out of this jam. You better not kill us, Nada Naga. I'm gonna look at this door. You peer through the grate. The door slams down, crushing the life from you and Nadia amid the sound of mighty hooves.
Do
Okay. We didn't die. I did something and it didn't die. I push and pull. It remains firmly shut. Nadia walks around the cavern, staring at each part of every wall, the ceiling, and floor. You push and pull in an attempt to open the door. It remains firmly shut. Nada looks stumped. Then, as if suddenly understanding something, she shifts her search back to the second door. This one? Just look at it. The door looks like an oblong coffin mounted on the wall of the cavern. It is closed. Nadia slowly passes her hands over the door and it slowly slides open. She beckons you to follow her through it. Hi, Senior Soto. Hi, Barfi. Hi, Gamer. Somehow that worked that time, but now that makes me think that it would have also worked with the other characters and maybe I just did the wrong thing. But we're stuck with Nadia here, guys. Can you only get through that with Nadia? Hello, screen. Who are you? My name's Doug. What's yours? Who are these guys? I'm Kim. I'm a mundane just like you, except I don't believe in magic, and it's obvious that you don't. Except I believe in magic, and you don't. How do you know that? Because you're still shaped like a screen. You won't get very far in Xanth looking like that, you know. Oh, that's me. That's me right now. I'm this little screen. I don't care how far I get, I'm just playing this game on a dare. You have to pick Naga. Okay, thanks, Syllogism. All the better for me, then. I'll be certain to win the prize. Say, why don't we team up and go look for this prize together? You die anyway, might as well kiss the demon. No way, you don't even believe in magic. I'm not gonna saddle myself with a non-believer like you. Well, I'll see you later, Doug. Unless you stay a screen, that is. In that case, you won't last long enough for me to see you again at all. We're this floating screen. And who's your friend? Just got like a gym teacher. Your companion's a gym teacher? From the 70s? What's up with the speed of this animation, too? It's so slow. Okay, you've made it to Xanth. You want to know more about the game of the prize. I know about as much as you, I do. However, I know a lot about this place, so if you have any other questions, ask away. As Kim mentioned, you're going to be shaped like a computer screen while in Xanth. This is a result of the way you've entered Xanth in a combination with your disbelief of Xanth as a real place. You don't believe this is a real place, do you, Doug? If this is real, why am I shaped like a screen? Yes, this is definitely real. Okay, if this is real, why am I shaped like a screen? Because you don't believe in magic, and because you entered Xanth through a mundane computer screen. Now, do you believe this is all real, Doug? I'm not sure, but if pressed, I'd say no. As I suspected, as long as you have not suspended your disbelief, you will remain shaped as a screen. Until you believe that Xanth is a real place, and until you completely believe in the magic that exists here, you will appear to everyone here as a screen. As a screen, you will be able to perform most actions, but will be slightly impaired because of your strange shape. You will occasionally require my assistance, and this is the one reason I'm here. I can also offer you advice about how to find the prize and possibly win the game. It didn't let me choose yes. I would have liked to choose yes. Alright, we got out of the damn cavern. Jeez. We're gonna have to save a lot. Out of cave 3. Oh, hi, Wormillion. Oh, my lord. Okay, so those others are trolls. This game will troll me. Let's go into that cave. It's an opening of another Xanthian cavern, probably not unlike the one you just emerged from. That was intense. Cave exit. Brook. Look at the brook. The barely audible brook winds off toward a small bridge to the north. Okay. Go. Alright. We got some butterflies, fireflies, let's catch some. Fireflies with this plastic. Wait, I thought he said I couldn't bring things between worlds, but I've got the paper and the plastic. Is that because it was wrapping the game? Alright, I don't want to mess with anything. Let's look at the fireflies. Swarm of fireflies, okay. Let's look at the brook. It's a babbling brook. Okay, let's swim in the brook. You dip your edge of the screen into the babbling brook and decide it's too cold for a pleasant stream. Yeah, you can paste an internet link. Paste all the links you want. The grows? The more pornographic, the better. That's a joke. Do not post porn, please. Thank you. Log jam. Take the log. You pull on the log with all your might, but it's firmly logged within the log jam. It's going to take some heavy tool to pry it loose. We need a tool to get this log out of the log jam. Log jam. Alright, let's go, southeast. You head down the trail, get very confused, and retrace your steps to the crossroads. Fair enough, let's go east. Oh, spring path, tangle tree. Look at the tangle tree. It's a tangle tree, just like in the books. Climb the tangle tree. Nada turns to you irritated. What's wrong? Don't you know anything about Xanth, Doug? I thought tangle trees were notorious even in Mundania. One false step too near a tangle tree in your history. Sorry, princess, I didn't know. Wise up, Doug. Xanth's a very dangerous place. Sheesh. Shouldn't climb that. I'm sure you get Tom naked pictures on the internet. Nice, Mandarin. Thanks to Gross for posting my Twitch channel in my Twitch chat. That's very helpful. Thank you. Let's drink from the spring. We're doing all the dangerous moves. Screens can't drink, Doug. Oh, right, we're still a screen. I keep forgetting. Look at the spring. You look into the pool and see a hazy image of bodies moving about. You kneel down and study the image carefully. You recognize Kim, Jenny Elf, and Sammy Cat approaching a shoreline. Oh, so they got Jenny Elf and Sammy Cat. That was Jenny Elf. It looked like a gym teacher. That looks like a gym teacher. How is that the nerd girl? Oh, Kim is the gym teacher. Okay, my bad. Look, Jenny Elf, there in the water. What is that? Can't see anything. It's a merman, Kim. Don't pay any attention to him. Let's keep moving. Retrograde.com. That's my best website. No, I want to talk to him. But it will take too much time. I'm sure you're ahead of Doug. Don't you want to win the prize? Sure, but this will only take a few minutes. Look, he's getting out of the water. Please get eaten. Eat her. Eat her. Yes, eat her. Hello, ladies. Hi, my name's Kim. I'm from Mundania. This is Jenny Elf and Sammy Cat. What's your name? Are you really a merman? Do you live in the water? What happened to your tail? Whoa, slow down. My name is Cyrus. Yes, I'm a merman, and yes, I live in the water, but changing my tail into legs is my special talent. It's kind of painful, but I can change back anytime I want to.
If it hurts, then why did you do it?
It's time for me to seek out a wife, but there are no eligible merwomen in this part of the water wing. The two of you look like adventurers out on a journey, so I thought I would ask if I can walk along with you until I can find a suitable merwoman to marry.
That sounds like fun. Let's get going, and while we walk, you can tell me what it's like to live in the water. Do you have both lungs and gills? Do you eat fish? Do you sleep on a waterbed?
Well, it looks like Kim is getting all sorts of nice, great companions. All I'm doing is drinking from a pond. Kim seems to be quite a competent mundane, Doug. If I were you, I'd be a little worried if you want to win the game. And Jenny Elf looks like a pretty competent companion.
She seems alright, but I believe you won't find me lacking in any important way as your companion.
Where would you say they are right now?
From the looks of the geography, I'd say that was near the outskirts of the water wing. Is that far from here? Yes, Doug, very far.
The dude in red was Kim. Let's check out this bush. This is a cough drop bush, Doug. Apparently it's dormant in its dormant period. When they're active, these bushes cough and drop cough drops at regular intervals. Really, truly? Really, Doug, and you better start taking this place seriously or else. Or else what? Or else your time here will be limited and you'll return home without the prize. Youch, I better get with the program. Look, I didn't ask to be assigned to you. You picked me, and for better or worse, you're stuck with me. Heed my advice, you'll most certainly blunder into peril at this place. One thing that I'm worried about. We're a woman. We're a million. We're a woman. It's very close. One thing I'm worried about is if this game is timed like the spellcasting series. Because then every time I want to just explore the world, we're waiting and time is passing and we're screwing ourselves. We're getting screwed. We have to murder Kim? I would love to. Hi, Coyote. Hi, Glitch. Glitch posted a GIF. I'm going to click on the GIF. Zelda Speedrunners. Nice. Oh, yeah. That's a cool gif. He, hits, that bomb with his shield. He's standing at the center of a small village. Nada hums a pleasant tune. Alright, let's talk to Headband. Hello, mundane screen and beautiful Naga princess. I am a woodwright by trade, and the appointed headman of Isthmus Village. Please state your business here. Hi, we were just browsing. Yeah, right. Answer the question, screen. I don't have any. Are you in business here?
Yes, I'm a woodwright. I cut wood right. If you would bring me some wood, I would probably be able to fashion that wood to your liking.
You would?
I would. Wood right, huh? How about you give me some wood right now? That's not the way it works, Screen. You bring me the wood and I make it right. Okay, I gotta bring him wood. We gotta get that wood out of the lake, bring it to him. He's gonna shave it up for us, and then we're gonna... whatever. Get whatever we need for the next thing. Tell me what's happening around these parts, Headman. The town has many problems. Our worst is the dread ship that lies at the anchor in our harbor. Tell me more, Headman. The ship is a censor ship. It censors what we say. Incense rising from the censors aboard the vessel pervades the town, censoring us and incensing us. That's a bleep of a bleep. Wow, it really is a censor ship. Will you help us rid ourselves of this bleep municipal malady? Yes. Sure. None of us in the village has been able to find a way beyond the pale that lies northeast of here. Only there can the solution be found. We hope you can do what we cannot. Take this strange rusty key as a sign of our gratitude, Wandering Screen. Fair enough. Dwells beyond the pale and can supply you with a solution with which to douse the foul censors aboard the ship. Okay. What do you think the solution to the... I almost said effing, because it says bleep. To the bleeping ship, Headman. Alright, it's available from Fair Enough. Okay, yeah, got it. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, Vinylinen, how you doing today? What's up? Alright, we gotta get wood for that guy. What about these flowers? Pick a flower. As you reach out to pick a red blossom, a village ordinance nymph intervenes, preventing your horticultural crime. There's the censorship over there. Let's listen to it. You hear the hissing of whatever's burning within the censors and incensing the villagers. Oh man, puns. Unlimited puns. The puns are so deep. Exactly, Rethix. You're in a barren road running between steep cliffs. Nada looks bored. Why are you bored? What's wrong with you? Get excited. Explain your talent again. I'm a Naga. In my natural form, my body takes on the shape of a serpent with my human head. My magic talent is the ability to make my entire body appear human. That's a pretty dumb talent. What do you think we should do now? There lives a magician in Xanth named Humphrey, who is renowned for providing adventurers like yourself with direction. If anyone in Xanth knows what this prize is or where to look for it, he does. Where can we find him? Well, you know where the village is. I bet we could get some help from someone there. Okay, back to the game, princess. Excuse me, princess. You've got a boulder here. I have a feeling I should just save a bunch. Town 4. In case there is a timing thing, and in case I try to beat the game. Get on that boulder. How you could wish you could climb things and get out of the confines of the screen. We're still a screen! I don't see anything here. Sky. What's up, the sky? If you were a bird, you could fly around in it. I wish I was a bird. Alright, let's go down the road somewhere. Hey, here's a bucket. You're on a path that winds through gently rolling hills. Take the pail. Oh! Yo! Get back here, bucket. You reach down to take the pail and it leaps into the air. It lands far in the distance. Looks like the pail notices you throwing something at it and jumps out of the way, just in the nick of time. Perhaps if we were able to get far enough away, it wouldn't be able to sense its impending doom. What conclusions would you draw from that astute observation, princess?
If there was a way of hitting it without it seeing you, you might be able to get to something heavy inside it.
Of course, why didn't I think of that?
That's why you've been supplied with an expert companion, Doug.
I gotta do a voice for her. Hey, Morpheus. I'm gonna turn the volume down a little bit on this. I don't know if it's a little bit too loud. I'm just gonna turn it down a little bit. If I should turn it back up, let me know. Okay, so we've gotta somehow sneak up on that freaking bucket. Let's look at this key. It's the rusty old skeleton key Headman gave you. Silent Age and Silent Death. What are those, Morpheus? Is this a professional profile? What do you mean? The stream? No, I'm not a professional. I'm an amateur. I just turned the sound back up. Okay, let's continue on the path. Something about this bucket. Hey, there's that damn bucket again. I don't know how to sneak up on you right now, so I'm skipping the bucket. No, okay, whatever. I don't care what's in the bucket. You're in a path that... yeah. Keep moving. It's bucket. Just leave me alone, bucket. Professional god. I'm a professional goat god. I think this is just an endless path. It is. It is just an endless path. Just takes you back and forth. Forever. Until you can sneak up on this bucket. Farts.
Okay. Well, we can't do that. We gotta figure out how to get into that bucket. And then we can open this. Wait, open this gate. Maybe we need to unlock this gate and then go this way. Unlock the gate with this key. Oh, they're adventure games? Okay. I'll look at them. I'll write them down. Just drop my pen. I'll write them down. Silent Age, Silent Death. I wrote them down. Alright, we unlocked this gate. Let's open her up. Let's go this way, toward the boat. We also need to find that magician. You're standing upon a long wooden pier. You see a small scrap of cloth. A strand of rope is tied here. Nana looks bored. She's always bored. What do you want me to do about that? Take the sailcloth. Look at the sailcloth. It's a torn scrap from one of the ripped sails of the censorship, so we got some scrap. Or we better save it. Is there a quick save? Probably not. Just save it over the town thing again. Rope. There's a rope here. Take the rope. You pull on the rope length, but are unable to free it from the plank it's tied to. Something heavy is weighing it down. Oh yeah? Swim in the ocean. The Xanthian seas are notoriously dangerous. You need protective gear to swim anywhere around here. Maybe I have to cut this. Climb the rope? Look at the rope. It surrounds a plank on the pier. Okay, so this is... there's something hanging from this. Maybe we cut it and it floats to the top. Let's see what happens if we go into the boat. Oh, we got on the censorship. You're standing on the deck of the censorship. So maybe we just dump crap into this. Let's continue to go further into the boat. You're unable to find your way through the fumes and past the nearest sensor. Yeah, let's look at the smoke. Smoke billows from two sensors. Let's smell the smoke. You're incensed by the sensor smoke. You decide not to inhale again. In fact, you've never inhaled, but you did enjoy it. Okay. Let's douse the smoke with, Nada. Give the smoke to Nada. It's not mine to give. Okay, so this is the censorship boat. You read all the Xanths? Kaio, this is the 16th book. I've never read any of them. There's 40 of them right now. Doug, do you see the rope? Yes, I see it. I think I might be able to get it if I turned into my Naga form and crawled underneath the pier. Would you like me to give it a whirl? Sure. Go to it, princess. I only wish I could slither down there with you. Hang on, we'll be back in a jiffy. Found this anchor tied to the end of the rope, you notice. Perhaps you'll find these things useful in your quest for the prize. Thanks, I didn't realize your Naga form would turn out to be so useful. I'm certain this won't be the only time I come in handy, young mundane. Now please turn away so I may return to my human form and get dressed. Okay, I'm not looking. It's alright, I'm already dressed. Did we just get an anchor? Oh, we just got a... it looks like a fish hook. Look at the anchor. It's an anchor, you know, for keeping boats from moving. Okay, not sure what to do with that yet. We might be able to use that on the wood. Let's get back this way and try to find the magician, perhaps. Do we need to mess with this? This is a cough drop bush. Like, how let's pick it? You grope around in the bush and find nothing to pick. Let's shake it? Shaking the bush isn't going to free any of the cough drops, Doug. You have to wait for them to drop. Okay, maybe we come back here later and get a cough drop. And then the spring, I can see... Kim in the spring? Looks like an ordinary forest spring now. Okay, let's go back. Is the game as fun as farting in wizard class? It's a different type of fun. Okay, let's try using this. Pry the log with the anchor. Nailed it! You jam the anchor under the log and managed to pry it loose. Okay. Let's just look at this log jam again. Are we done with the log jam? Okay, let's go back to the wood man. Let's look at this wood. Just an ordinary log. So he's gonna cut this up into wood for me. Hey, dude, I got some wood for you. Here. That's a fine log you've got there, Screen. What would you have me do with it? Oh, I actually don't know what I need to make. You can either make a thin, flat board, firewood, or a fine wood carving. I don't know, got any ideas? Well, let's see. No, I can't think of anything that could be done with that truly fine hunk of tree. I guess we should wait until we know what we need. Unless you can't actually, make anything with it. I mean, unless you can't make the wrong thing. Let's go... came from this way, can't go this way. This way you get lost if you go this way. Get very confused and retrace your steps. So let's go this way.
the northwest. I know what you mean, John Freeman. You head up the trail to the northwest, get very confused, and retrace your steps. Well, shit. We can't go northwest, and we can't go southeast, and this is just the cave. And we don't go into the cave. Okay, so maybe we have to do something with that bucket. Dead age? Okay. It's dead age? Wait, dead age? Dead age. I'll write that down, too. Dead age. Never heard of those games. Look at the rope. It's coiled. Sorry, what if I tie the rope to the anchor? Nailed it. It's a fish hook. Look at the hook. Superbly constructed. Put the sailcloth on the anchor. Put the sailcloth on the log. Alright, I'm gonna save it and then see what I can make from this wood. Wood 5. Give this wood to this headman. I want to find wood carving. It would take me forever to complete a carving suitable to the tastes of one such as yourself. I must refuse your fine gift. Okay. Maybe you can't make the wrong thing. I'm just worried about dead ends. Thought you might want to use it as firewood. I could use a thin, flat board. In this way, I can be of assistance. I am a humble, plain man with an even humbler plane. While it is a plain plane, I believe it will do an adequate job of planing your wooden hunk. Is this what you desire? Yes, please help. Give me my freaking board. Consider it done. I'll be back here before you know it with a narrower version of your log. Nailed it. Good God, gamer. Let's take this rock. Alright, we got a rock, too. Anything else we need to get? Lamp cover? Lamp cover? What's up with this lamp cover? Take the lamp cover. Oh, we got the lamp cover, too? Take this lamp cover. Alright, we took all the lamp covers. I don't know why we took these. Maybe we can fill these later. Let's fill them with plastic. No. So we got two lamp covers too. As you can plainly see, here's the plain board you plainly encrusted. It was a pleasure to be of service to a screen such as yourself. Alright, so we got a board, we got the lamp covers. It's the plain board the woodwright made you. What else do you have to say? Have you accomplished anything yet? I rid Xanth of all evil except in this one town. I don't see how that's going to help us in the present bleeping situation. Good luck dousing the sensors, good screen. Thank you. Thank you, he gave me good luck. Wish me good luck. Hey, Tanda. I should write down butt. Alright, I'll write it down. Alright, what if I put this rock on this boulder? You put the rock on the boulder and it slips off and falls to the ground. You pick it up again and decide you need something flatter. Okay, well let's put this let's put this board on the boulder. Carefully place the plain board on the boulder upon which it firmly rests. What? That's interesting, Doug. It looks like a little mundane abstract sculpture. I didn't realize you possessed such an artistic flair, but I feel this sculpture needs a bit more. I just got 15 points for putting a board on this. Alright, put this... Yeah, put the lamp cover on the board. Before you actually put the lamp cover on the board, you chicken out and keep it. Alright, put the rock on the board. You carefully place the rock in position of the board you produced to catapult. Yes, that gives your sculpture a much more balance and a sense of ethereal lightness. I believe the various emotive structural motifs provide the viewer with a detached yet omnipresent viewpoint framework. Genius, pure genius. Oh yeah, we're so artistic. Tanda, what do you think of this art, huh? Okay, lamp cover on the board. Now, lamp cover on the rock. If you had some moss or lichens or some other similar green stuff, maybe you could put them on the rock, but a lamp cover won't do. Okay, what if I jump? It's a catapult. It's obviously a catapult. Look at the hook. Throw the hook at the board? You swing the grappling hook above your head, hearing it whip through the air. Just as you're about to release it at the board, the line gets fouled and the hook falls to the ground. You pick it up and recoil it. Okay. Put the hook at the lamp cover. I need a big, heavy boulder of some kind, or I need to jump on this. Let's talk to Nada. Make her jump on it. I like the music, too. Hey, oh, there we go. Nada, would you whack my catapult with your Naga tail? I'll be glad to slap your catapult with my Naga tail, Doug. Please stand back. We're doing pretty good. Somehow I'm getting solutions. Propelled by the force of Nada's mighty tail, the rock hurtles out of sight to the northeast. 8 points.
And it probably landed in the bucket, and then we can get the bucket. And we can't get the board anymore. It's wedged between the rock and the canyon wall. I was just joking about putting the rock on the thing. Take the pail now? Now we got the pail. You reach down and pick up the pail by its metal handle. Once it's in your possession, you remove the rock so you cleverly put there. You so cleverly put there. We got the rock and the pail. No, don't put the road in the pail. What are you doing? Look in the pail. The pail contains nothing. We got the pail. We got the pail, guys. We got the pail. Lichens. Lichens. Nada watches you. So now can we get past the bucket? Now we can get past the bucket! Oh, I'm surprised with myself. I mean, that's a pretty obscure solution, and somehow I accidentally found it. Because I just wanted to screw around and put a rock on a rock. Idor 6. This is gonna work out. Let's look at this first. Your large eye is inset on the screen door before you. It occasionally blinks, but soon resumes its gaze upon you. Okay. Well, I'm gonna steal your mail, if you don't mind. You open the mailbox and discover it contains a white envelope. I'm gonna take your mail. You mind if I read your mail? Let's read this letter. Hi, Ashke. Fair enough. We are beset by a terrible censorship that lies in anchor at our harbor and refuses to leave. Terrible incense is rising from the deck of the ship. Rising from the deck of the ship is censoring every effing S thing we say and incensing us. Please help us. Come quick. Signed, Headman Isthmus Village. Isthmus. Bunch of eyeballs. Bunch of freaking eyeballs. On the ground here. The music in some way reminds me of Kyrandia, though Kyrandia music is, you know, the ultimate of music from old adventure games. It's pretty close to that, I think. First try, look at the ice cream, eat the ice cream. All the screams gesticulate widely in the direction of the lone scream on the right side of the path nearest to you. A lone scream on the right side? Which one are you talking about? This one? Take? This one? Why are they pointing at that, at one eye? All the screams gesticulate wildly in the direction of the lone scream on the right side of the path nearest to me? What do you mean? What is that supposed to hint me toward? I have to take a certain eye? They're gesticulating wildly in the direction of the lone scream on the right side of the path nearest to me. It's all the same path. This one? What the hell's going on here? Open this door. I cannot let you pass until you've been properly eye-screened. I've never been screened by an eye on a screen door. Well, now you have, mundane dolt. Why am I wasting my time with you? Because I'm in a generally good mood? Because you're in a generally good mood and wish to do a good deed? I'm not in a good mood right now, and when I am, I still have no interest in the affairs of mundanes, let alone mundane screens. There are a few, I thought of another reason why you should listen to me. Okay, screen, I'm ready for your feeble attempt at reason. I should pay even the slightest heed to your mumbling. This better be good. Because you feel empathy for my cause? No. Well, that might be it. Because I have a lilting, melodious voice to soothe your troubles. If you sing, I will be forced to evict you from this space. Your voice is unpleasant enough without any singing. I'm actually playing a newer game than I played yesterday, Ashke. This game's newer. Yeah, Malcolm's Revenge music is really good, Earth Machine. Is there anything in there, or are you just a flat 2D sort of eye? A few things that are bothering me about you, eye. You know, I'm an eye screen too. Please allow me to pass. Not until I eye screen you. Well, screen me. How'd I let it screen me? Don't you feel a little vulnerable up there on that screen? Huh, your meager attempts at intimidation bounce off my screen and hit you in the face. Vulnerable? I don't even know the meaning of the word. You're losing me with all this eye screen stuff, I. Talking to yourself screen, I cannot properly screen a self-absorbed screen. Is there anything in there? Flat, yes, and rather two-dimensional now that you mention it. Had a few things that are bothering about me about you, I. Name one. You whine when you talk. Okay, maybe we can insult him to death. You whine a little when you talk. It's unnerving. That's the only voice I have, Screen. Be nice to it. It has a bad temper and an unpredictable mean streak. So another thing that's bothering me about you. You just stop staring at me? It's not nice to stare. What are you gonna do about it, foolish child? Maybe your mommy could help you out in this part of the game. It seems that the game is somewhat too strenuous for your weak body. I think you should blink more often. You seem stiff. If I could get out of this door, I'd stare you to death one day, and you've grown quite irritating to me. Be gone. Let's keep bothering it. I'm not used to eyes as large as you. It's a little freaky. And don't look at it, mundane. Turn this down a little bit more. Is that okay? Then don't look at mundane. Have you ever thought with your marble eye-sized eyeballs looked like to someone with large ocular endowments such as myself? They look like black-eyed peas. Keep annoying it. Keep annoying it. No. Another reason you should listen to me. Let's just say all these things real quick. Another reason. Let's try this one. You feel empathy for my cause. No, he doesn't. Because I'm physically beautiful. The Naga passes the test, but you are at best an adequate representative of your race. So I don't have any reasons to let this thing by. Let's see. We've got some new reasons here. Aren't you really just a helplessly big eyeball on a door? I know why you're asking me these questions, Mundane. Could confuse me. It'll never work. Okay, keep trying. Keep trying. I haven't got all day. Oh, really? What else is on your agenda today, Mr. I? I know why you're asking me all these questions to confuse me. Okay. Isn't this whole Ice Queen thing a complete sham? None of that's working. No. It's not working. I wish I had something long and pointy to screen you with. The kind of talk will get you nowhere with the Ice Queen, for whom I screen. Ice Queen? I don't see an Ice Queen. The Ice Queen resides behind these walls, Screen, preening and making her devious Ice Queenish plans. State your purpose here, or be off. The Ice Queen has no time for idling screens. We seek the fairy Nuff. Do you know where we might find her? The she you are referring to is a he. Mr. Nuff resides in a booth within the fair at the end of the fairway beyond the Ice Queen's abode. Why do you seek the fairy Nuff? I was told that he might help me find a certain solution. The people of Ith... A solution, huh? A solution to what? Just tell them what we need a solution for. Then you may proceed, Screen. Good luck on your Admiral quest. Oh! Damn, I insulted... I was spent all that time insulting. All we had to do was, let's put some snow in the pail. Put the pail in the snow. Put the snow in the lamp cover. Okay, let's go through the screen. We just had to tell her what we were doing. that's hilarious. Weird screen on that door. Damn. This game is pretty trolly. Okay, what is this? A T. Take the T. And we got the T. Let me look at the T. It's a wooden peg with a flattened top, giving it the shape of a letter T. Sand traps. Look at the sand traps. Yep, they're definitely sand traps. Golf must be big around these parts. Look at the sand that's been trapped. Let's go to the fair. So we can get some sand here, maybe. The fair. An egg? Okay, take the egg. You remove the egg from the cup and roll it around in your hand. 2 points. Look at the cup. The cup is a small container inset into the green. It's currently empty. Okay. Look at the egg. It's an egg of some sort. Ovate and otherwise uninteresting. Let's talk to this witch person here. Witch booth? Talk to the witch booth. As you study the witch booth, it says, as you study the witch booth, you lose track of which booth you were looking at. Very funny. Let's go to the clown booth. The clown booth seems to be in the business of selling balloons. Let's talk to the clown booth. The clown ignores you, his interest consumed with his balloons. Okay, fine. We can't go to any of the booths. Fine. Go to Fair Enough. Is this guy Fair Enough? Okay, this is guy's Fair Enough. He's got a wand. Look at his wand. It's a silly looking wand with a 5-pointed star at the end of it. Nuff's waving it around threateningly. He's also got a paper scroll. Let's look at it. Paper scroll's jammed into the front pocket of Nuff's lab coat. Okay, I'm gonna save it. Nuff 7. Alright, okay, let's check out the blackboard. Various complex equations are scribbled on the blackboard behind the fairy Nuff. They are all unintelligible to you. Okay, let's talk to him. What do you want, wandering screen and strange Naga person? Let's see. The headman of Isthmus Village is sentenced to obtain a solution.
He did, did he? What kind of solution were you looking for?
Isthmus Village is troubled by a ship that lies in its harbor, censoring the speech of the villagers. We were hoping you could help.
A censorship? That sounds serious. How many censors are set upon the deck of the ship?
2. I don't know. I think it was 2?
Ah, this is indeed a foul ship. I know it well. There was only one known solution to such a censorship. Prepare the solution by following this recipe. Come back when you properly made it. I will instruct you further upon your return should you succeed. Good luck.
Okay, we got the recipe. I think by censors they meant those big tubs on the, those big things that the smoke was coming out of. Mix 2 dashes of ice cream with 1 dash of butter and stir vigorously. Add 3 pints of fresh water, 2 cough drops, a firefly, a large egg, and mix thoroughly. Finally, add a fragment of the object upon which the solution will be applied and mix again. Now, hold on. When did Kyrandia come out? This game's starting to feel like Kyrandia. When the hell did Kyrandia come out? 92, 93, 94. Just saying, this game's starting to feel like Kyrandia.
Okay,
yeah, I'm gonna try to do more voice acting on any chance. So we need 2 dashes of ice cream with 1 dash of butter and stir vigorously. Add 3 pints of fresh water, 2 cough drops, a firefly, a large egg. We can get the firefly, we get the egg, we got the egg, we got the firefly, the cough drops we know where to get, the water I think we can get, the butter, I don't know where to get the butter, so we have to figure out how to get butter. We know where to get the ice cream too. Add a fragment of the object upon which the solution will be applied. The wood. No, not the wood. We gave that away already. The T. Look at the T. It's giving it the shape of the letter T. Oh, he gave me the scroll. Give me the wand. Take the wand.
Hey, you know, this wand don't really a bit of good, Mundane. Only in the hands of fairy enough can its awesome power be unleashed. Stand back, lest I unleash it upon you and your serpentine friend.
Okay. Well, she's actually in her human form right now, but okay. Let's go back, and we gotta figure out how to get butter now, guys. Butter, to get make butter, we need milk. Or we need to buy it from somewhere. Let's look at the booths. Maybe we can get butter? Yeah, I don't think there's anything we can do with this. Fair. The green? Like a golf ball? What if I put this rock in this cup? Putting the rock anywhere on the green would be littering, punishable by a severe fine. Now, there's nothing in this pail, right? That's how we make our thing. Now, I don't know if it's time-based, what if I just put this egg in the bucket now? Whoops. Well, okay, I hope that's what I was supposed to do. And let's try to go get some of the other stuffs now. Oh, I bet you maybe I... Okay, put the ice cream in the pail. Okay, we got the ice cream in the pail. We needed 2 dashes, right? Okay, so that's 2 dashes of the ice cream. Wrong one. Wrong document. Ice cream and butter, yeah. Butter. 2 dashes of ice cream. 1 egg. Firefly, cough drops, fresh water. We'll go with that stuff. Try to go get the water. Now, would snow be... What's the snow count? The snow can't be taken. Okay, it doesn't count as fresh water. I thought it might count as fresh water. We need butter, guys. How do we get butter? I don't know where to get butter. I haven't seen anywhere to get butter yet. And I haven't seen a cow. Let's go try to at least get the cough drops. I don't see. A lone firefly buzzes from tree to tree. Nada looks about. You hear a cough. A drop falls from the bush into the spring, making a small splash. Look at the spring. Just like an ordinary fire spring now. It said there was a cough drop in here. Take the spring. Well, because I took the mail out, Tonda. It was my bad. You churn it with from milk. You can't take the spring. You hear a cough. A drop falls from the bush. Okay. Put the pail in the spring. A foul scent emanates from the spring. It's clearly not the fresh water the recipe calls for. But I want to catch the... I want to catch the thing by putting the drop under it. Look at the drop bush. Coughing sound emanates from the strange bush. You hear a cough. A drop falls from the bush into the spring. These drops are constantly falling into the bush. We need to figure out how to get it. Put the plastic in the spring. I need to catch... You hear a cough. It keeps dropping into the spring. I don't... Put the paper in the drop bush.
I'm trying to figure out a way to get the drop. There's a bunch of drops in the spring. How do we catch it? Put the sailcloth in the spring. If we were to put the sailcloth in the spring, you might lose it. Put the rock in the spring. I gotta figure out how to catch the drops. Look at the tangle tree. If we get too close to that, we'll be screwed. Put the tea in the spring. No. These drops just keep falling. Get on the path. You're already on it. Swim in the spring. Maybe we can catch it if we swim in the spring. It keeps falling in there. Nada, go get the cough drops, please. Let's talk to Nada. Maybe Nada will help. Could you get one of those cough drops? No problem, Doug. Just wait until the next cough. Oh, okay. We can make Nada do it. Great. I'll just wait. Look at the spring. Look at the bush. Okay. No, it's not working. Look at the bush. She got the cough drop. Nailed it. A drop falls from the bush and Nada catches it. Okay, I need you to do that one more time. Whoops, that was an accident. I didn't mean to give it to her. Gotta squeeze the cow's butters. Alright, I need another cough drop, Nada. And wait until the next cough. We'll get the cough drops. We figure out how to get the cough drops. We got two cough drops. Drop them in the bucket. Cough drops in the pail. Alright, so that's the cough drops. Now we need the fresh water. I need you to get me a firefly now, Nada. Get your firefly with a lamp cover. Oh, you scoop a single firefly into the lamp cover, but it immediately escapes. We have to figure out how to block this thing off. Put the lamp cover in the lamp cover. Put the lamp cover on the sailcloth. They wouldn't be at all appreciative if you lost it. What? Put the lamp cover on the plastic. Put the plastic on the lamp cover. Put the rock in the lamp cover. Put the tea in the lamp cover. Put the paper on the lamp cover. Okay, brook. Swim in the brook. Spring, waterfall. Look at the waterfall. Small waterfall. Look at the brook. It's a babbling brook. Okay. Put the waterfall, fill the pail with the waterfall. You hold the pail in the waterfall and collect about 2 cups of water in it. Is that the same as 3 pints? Pints, 2 cups. It said 3 pints, I think. 3 pints. 1 pint is 2 cups. So we need 6 cups. If it's pints. So let's check. Recipe. Said 3 pints, right? 3 pints. So we need to get 2 more doses of this. And then we just have to get the firefly, and then we have to get the butter. Okay, there's our 3 pints. Gotta chase waterfalls if you want to complete this recipe. Look at the bridge. It's a smaller bridge spanning the babbling brook. And can we go this way now? Still can't go that way. I'm getting confused. So, a couple of things we have to figure out: how to take the firefly, how we can not get confused when we take 2 of these paths. How to make butter, what to do with this tea. We also need a piece of what the material is going to, goop is going to be and the potion is going to be on. Yeah, I don't need the cough drop. Let's go back to the ship. Now I'm assuming I can use this little bit of sailboat piece, right? Because it's going on a sailboat and this is part of a boat. So I'm thinking that that's what this is. It's 2, right? Just 2 of these. Smoke, sensor. Look at the sensor. Coughing and wheezing, yeah. Still just a sensor. You found the Russian version of It's My Life? Thanks, Dave. That's cool. Magic popcorn dip sauce. Let's read this again. An oven mitt? Yeah, maybe. Well, the thing is, because we could catch it in the lamp cover. But it said it immediately escaped, which makes me think we need to add something to the lamp cover. Okay, let's see. We got the ice cream. We got the... Oh, maybe I can turn ice cream into butter? By churning it, right. Right, right. We got the cough drops, we got the water, we got the large egg. A fragment of the object upon which the solution will be applied. So that's probably the piece of the sail. We've got rope. Now let's see. I wonder if I needed to churn the ice cream first, and I'm dead ended. look at the paper. Is this butter? What's happening to the sound? It's brown paper wrapping from the package Ed sent you. An oven mitt. Alright, help me. Greetings, have you accomplished anything yet? Name one. I think I'm really close to a major breakthrough. I don't see how that's gonna help us in the present effing situation. Good luck dousing the sensors. So the closest thing we have to butter is probably that ice cream, but I haven't seen a churn. I kind of have an idea if I can get some more ice cream, but I don't know how to just get ice cream. Nada hiccups. Talk to Nada. Help me. How am I doing with the solution? Let's see, you've collected 2 dashes of ice cream, 3 pints of water, an egg, and 2 cough drops. You need a dash of butter, something from the censorship, and a firefly. Oh, so I don't have the thing from the censorship. This is not it. It's like, you could use this to make butter, because it's like, if it's like a cheesecloth, right? You need a cheesecloth to make butter? Is that right? Okay, let's start trying to mix everything with this. Rock with the lamp cover. Envelope with the lamp cover. Tea with the lamp cover. Lamp cover with the lamp cover. Now there was this one area where it was just one firefly. Maybe I need to... We can't take this board back, right? Ba-da-ba-dum-bum-bum. How do you make butter from ice cream? Yeah, you're right. It's probably not ice cream. But it's the only dairy thing that I have seen. Can I light this? Light this. The streetlights are only lit at night, conserving the costly fuel that Ethmuth Village, with its decreasing tax base, cannot afford. There could be something we haven't clicked on. We've got this T. What's going on here? Distant cliffs and a sky. I don't think anything's here. I think if you tried hard enough, you could make butter from ice cream. What if you melt the ice cream and then churn it? Can we eat some of this? No, they just gesticulate. Can we take some more of this? What if I put ice cream in the lamp cover? Put ice cream in the lamp cover. No. Put ice cream on the tea. Put tea in the ice cream. Anything else here? Icicles? Take an icicle? No can do. The ice cream won't permit you to arm yourself with such a deadly weapon. Alright, let's go back to this. Can you catch fireflies with the lanterns? Right, I tried that, but they just flew out. If I could light these, but this is just a lamp cover. I don't know how to light those. It says the lanterns only get lit at night. This is just a lamp cover. If I could fill this, fill the lamp cover with... I don't really know what to fill it with. With snow or something else. Fill it with sand. Fill the lamp cover with sand. Okay, something with sand traps on the hook. There's this hole here, this cup here. Nada looks hungry. Nada, got any new hints? What do you think we should do now? I can see you need some help with your recipe. I do, I've never been a very good cook. How am I doing? She's not telling me what to do. We have to figure it out on our own. Can wear it? Can wear what? Witch booth. The clown booth. A banner. Clown. Something with the clown. Or the green. Take green. What about some of this stuff? Nuff's junk. Look at Nuff's junk. Beakers, test tubes, and flasks are arrayed upon the fairy's table, bubbling and smoking towards some unknown purpose. Drink Nuff's junk? I should save it before I drink Nuff's junk. Nuff's junk. Let's drink Nuff's junk. You have to transform junk's Nuff to liquid to drink it. Shake it. Nuff's junk could be explosive. Pour Nuff's junk on the pail. Bad idea. Nuff's junk are an ingredient in the solution you're preparing. Pour Nuff's junk into this lamp cover. Lamp covers had a wear? Oh, they do? Oh. The lamp cover would make a ridiculous hat. Look at the key. We got a T. It's spelled like a T. Do I want to use T anything? T on anything? Don't think we've missed anything here. Let's go back screen by screen and try to make sure we haven't missed anything. Scaffolding. Look at the scaffolding. The Ice Queen's palace was more like a cheap Hollywood set. Oh well, it seemed pretty convincing. Let's climb it. New area. Screens really aren't designed for climbing scaffolding, Doug. Maybe later if you believe. Oh, we can't climb because we're just a screen. We're a computer. No, we can't take the scaffolding. Wait, look at this door. Knock on the door. You rap several times on the wooden door and then stand frozen several minutes in a meditative trance. Look at the door. The wooden door is open. So there's sand here. Still am clueless how to get butter. Like, maybe something at the fair that I missed? Let's see. Look at this green. It's a golf green. The witch booth. Talk to the clown booth. He ignores me. Talk to the witch booth. It's unclear which witch you want to converse with. Look at the banner. It says fair. Look at these booths. Various booths line the thing. Okay. Talk to the scaffolding. Yeah, I was wondering if I could collect the sand too. I don't have anything to collect it in. The sand traps and the lamp cover. I don't know what I would need the sand for. Look at the T. Okay, hold on. So, put the T on the fairway. We can put the T back down. Then put a rock on the T. We can put the T back down. So we can play golf. The rock on the fairway? I want to put the rock on the tee. It doesn't let me. I can throw this rock. Throw the rock at the tee. No. Let me take the tee. At least we know we can put it back down. Let's try throwing... Let's throw the rock at the clown booth. You think long and hard and searching for a reason to throw the rock at the clown booth. You can't think of one. Let's throw it at the witch booth. We can throw the rock. I wonder what we might want to throw the rock at. Can we combine anything? Moss or lichens? You can put mosses and lichens on the rock. It's a large, hefty rock you're proud to possess. We've got plastic. We've got a rock. Are we at the spot where we want to start mixing everything with everything else? I need butter. I need to get the firefly somehow, which I need to make some kind of container to hold it. I don't have moss or lichens. I can put the tea back down, which is interesting. There's something else in that box. I wish we could have thrown the rock at the clown booth. See anything else here? Are we pixel hunting? I forgot why I don't normally stream adventure games. I'm fine now, but because you can get stuck real hardcore. And then you have to decide when you want to actually look up the answer. Okay, so we've got two of these lamp covers. We can fill them, we can pour them. We can pour the lamp cover. So, can we fill these with something? We can fill these. Fill the lamp cover with... a pail? No. Let's see, okay. Maybe... can I fill it with ice cream? And then churn? Let's go back and see if we can fill it with ice cream. I thought I already tried that, though. Lichens pronounced lichen? But I want to pronounce it lichen. I counter with, I want to pronounce it a different way. What about that? Okay. Fill? Is there anything else we can fill this with? Fill the lamp cover with ice cream. Just a smushed eye? Fill the lamp cover with snow. We can fill these lamp covers with something, but I don't know what we need to fill them with. Maybe if the cough drops are falling into that spring, it'll be sweet water, and it'll attract the firefly. Let's go try that now. Kind of like a second-rate Kyrandia soundtrack, which means still good, but not as good. You hear a cough. Okay, so this is sweet stuff here. So what if we fill it with this sweet stuff? Yes! You dunk the lamp cover in the spring and collect some clear water in it. Okay, so now the firefly is going to get trapped. Well, that should get us the firefly. Because it's sweet water because of the cough drops. Okay. Put the lamp cover on the fireflies? You couldn't fit the fireflies. Catch a firefly with this lamp. You couldn't fit the fireflies through the narrow opening in the lamp cover. What the hell, man? Put the lamp cover in the lamp cover. Okay, I have to pour this on something. It's a common streetlight. So I've got the clear blue water in the lamp cover. Let's see. Can I also just do it with this? I can just do it with regular water, too. Clear water. If I look at this, it says clear blue water. I think I was wrong. That was not right. Lickin'. Skitchin'. Lickin'. Thanks, Oni-chan. Yeah, I filled the lamp with water. You can fill these lamps with water, but it's not really help. I don't know what to do with it next. Catch a firefly with a tea. Okay, what do we want to pour water on? I don't think I want to pour it in here. That would totally ruin this. Damn. Save. Pouring. Pouring 9. Pouting. Pouting is fine. I'm also pouting. Hi, NES Gamester. Okay, you attempt to pour them into the pail and miss, spilling them on the ground. Alright, so got two lamp covers. What about this tree? What's going on with this tree? It's a garden or forest variety tree. What happens if we climb this tree? Screens can do a lot in Xanth, but they can't climb trees. What else is here that we can touch? Let's look at this tree. Gnarled old tree has small red fruit that are just within your reach. Alright, red fruit. Pick the red fruit. We found something new. We got a cherry. Pick a red fruit and discover it to be a cherry bomb. Okay, we've got a cherry bomb now. They're harmless looking fruit or cherry bombs. Be careful, they explode on impact. Alright, now we can kill those clowns. Okay, that's why you gotta explore. So if I catch the firefly with this, this is what it says. You scoop a single firefly into the lamp cover, but it immediately escapes. So we can... There's a hint that we can catch a firefly in this lamp cover. There's also... We can also fill these with water for some reason. Like we need to water a flower. Let's look at this bridge. And if we try to go northeast, northwest, or southeast, we get confused. We've got an envelope. Let's open the envelope. We've got an open, sealed envelope. We've got a key, we've got 3D glasses, we've got paper, we've got plastic. We've got a key, we've got a sailcloth, which I feel like we're going to use as a cheesecloth, but I don't know what this is for. It's a torn scrap from one of the ripped sails. Use this on the cherry bomb. Use this on the pail. That was what we needed to fill the pail. Okay, so that's the piece of the sailboat, so we just need butter and a firefly. And I don't know how to get it. Let's see, what if I throw a rock at these fireflies? Get out of here. You think long and hard. Okay, I have an idea. Let's throw the cherry bomb at this tangle tree. Let's throw the cherry bomb at the forest. No, at the tangle tree. You throw the cherry bomb in the forest, it disappears in a small red puff. Small red puff, huh? Braxton. Wee. What's this on the ground? It looks like buttercups. Buttercups! I found the buttercups! We got the butter! I got the butter, guys! Put the butter in the pail! Now we just gotta figure out... Oh, wait, it's right here. I have to extract the butter from the flower? What do you mean? It's right here. Look at the buttercup. We got a small sticky yellow flower containing some butter. You put the tea in the buttercup? There isn't any way to jam the tea inside the buttercup. Take the butter. Okay, I had to dump it out of the flower, and now I put it in the pail. We got the butter. May we. Blow the fireflies up. We could try that. Throw the cherry bomb at the fireflies. It didn't really work. Okay, let's take another cherry bomb. Alright, so we got the butter. We got everything we need except for this damn firefly. Maybe if I put the buttercup in the lamp cover with the water, it'll land on the... You couldn't fit the buttercup through the narrow opening in the lamp cover. What do you mean, the narrow opening in the lamp cover? Putting the buttercup in the lamp cover will not have a beneficial result. Let's look at the buttercup. Got a small sticky yellow flower containing nothing. It's sticky. Catch the fireflies with the buttercup. Nailed it. Okay.
You whip the buttercup back and forth through the swarm for a few seconds and catch a single bug within it. It becomes stuck within the sticky flower, unable to escape. Alright, now put the firefly in the pail. How many fireflies do we need? Let's read the recipe. Hey, broken beans. Yep, we got it. We did it. We did that. Just one firefly. Sweet. We're actually figuring this out without hints. Put the firefly in the pail. That's everything we need. You squirt the firefly out of the flower and into the pail. The mixture bubbles for a moment, overflowing the sides of the pail, and changes to a sickly green color. It seems you prepared the solution. Alright. Now we bring it back to Ferryman. We're good to go, and we also got cherry bombs for good measure. So we have to make sure we really explore all these areas, or else we'll miss things, and we won't be able to complete the game. And I'll be very mad. Build me up, buttercup, baby. Butter cups? Whose cups? So we can also fill these with water, and I don't know why, but that's good useful information. Yeah, I always figure out things without hints, that's true. But I'm just pointing it out that I'm doing it again, this time, Cosmotic 007s. Always figure everything out without hints. Never used a hint on this channel, not once. Never. Don't need it. Too good of a gamer. Alright, here you go. Here you go, fair enough. Now that you provided the solution and two equivalent receptacles for it, I'll divide it evenly between them and turn them to you. Now go forth and douse the censoring senses. By the way, I'm keeping the pail in my recipe, and I dispose of the swill you had in the covers. Oh, the swill I had in the covers? I didn't have swill in covers. Thanks a lot, pal. I'm really having fun now. Me too, at your expense, I'm afraid. This is great. Now I've got two full things full of glop instead of one. Be thankful for what I have provided. On another day, I might not have been so benevolent. What am I supposed to do, wear these on my head? Yes, I think you look quite nice in either of them. Hey, I've grown attached to that pail. Give it back. This is my pail, and I've only loaned it to you long enough for you to mix that horrid crud you've got there in those lamp covers. Oh, I see. It puts them in the lamp covers, and for some reason, we can also fill them with water. I get it now. Okay, let's go do the deed. Yes, get on with your dousing, mumbling fool. It is only out of extreme benevolence that I extend such a favor upon a sniveling screen such as yourself. I keep forgetting we're a screen, and it's pretty damn funny. Okay. Alright, what's our next challenge? Is that the end of the game? Maybe we beat the game. It's easier to navigate these games too, because you just use the compass here. You don't have to like walk all the way through a screen, you know, it's quicker. Alright, so let's douse these in the things. Douse the sensor with the solution. It's one. Oh, I have to do it here first. Douse the sensor with the solution. Okay, you approach the sensor and are overpowered by the noxious fumes. You force yourself closer and empty the contents of the lamp cover onto it. After a few coughs and wheezes, the sensor stops emitting fumes. Okay. Let's do it on this one. What do you mean? Go toward it. You have to go closer to it. Whoa! The menacing bowl is belching horrible fumes. Nada hesitates. You gasp for air. Quick! We're gonna pass out. Struggling, you overcome the choking forms of the sensor. You force the lamp cover over the edge of the infernal bowl. With every bit of willpower you can muster, you force your hand to overturn the cover, spilling its contents into the sensor. Alright. Did it. I think we just beat the game. No, we didn't beat the game. We beat the first challenge in the game. So, Demon Xanth, the mundane boy has finally come to believe in your magic. Okay, so now I don't have to be a screen anymore? Yes, Demon Earth, although it has cost him precious time, the girl is already far ahead. True, but do you think there's a long way to go? Do you think there's still a long way to go? Do you think he suspects the stakes of our wager? No, he remains ignorant. I am certain that he has not yet dug up that information. Arg, another of your infernal puns. Eternity is arduous enough without having to endure your pitiful attempts at humor. When you lose this wager, perhaps you'll also lose your taste for wordplay. These are like the gods of the different worlds.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Arg! They talk about it every time I complete Vape Nation. Every time I complete a thing, let's smell the sensor. Doug, you've done it. You've come through. You're here in Xanth. You no longer appear to us as a screen. I must admit I'm surprised. Dousing that last sensor must have increased your belief that Xanth is in fact real. How does it feel to believe? Feels good to get out of that screen. You should be proud you have conquered the evil censorship, and now that you believe in magic, your other challenges in Xanth should be easier to manage. I feel mightier already. Whatever you say, Doug. I wish we could have another cool companion. Hey, Runeword. I wish we could have all the companions, but the gym teacher got the cat girl. The cat and the girl. We just got this Naga lady that doesn't seem to like us very much.
You've done it, the wicked senses, you killed them.
I guess I did, didn't I? Aren't I wonderful like a hero?
As headman of Ithrasilj, I present this token of our gratitude and respect. We're not exactly sure what sort of sword it is, but we're sure you'll find out in the course of your travels.
We're taking back our key, our lamp covers, and our town rock. Do you have any final requests of us?
What's so important about that darn rock? The town rock has occupied that location in Ithrasilj for over 2 centuries. The story is told of how the great rock served as a projectile in some ancient type of machination, showering terror down upon its foes. Other than that, we just like it.
If I'd known that part about the ancient weapon, this whole job would have been immeasurably easier.
Yeah, oh well.
I like the sword. It's very pointy. What do you know about it?
Not much. It's a sword. It's very old. It's got a pointy tip. That's about it.
I guess you don't know much about the sword.
Okay, I gotta go. Bye.
We're gonna go take those other paths. The sword that we got. Look at the sword. The sword from the Ithrasilj headman made is very smooth gold metal. Good. I'm happy that we have that sword. Now let's go this way. I can't go that way. Can I go this way? I can't go that way either. Maybe I need to take the boat? Can I go in this? Let's go back in the cave. I want to go in the cave. Can't go back in the cave. Can't go those two ways. What if I wield the sword? Look at the sword. Yeah, we gotta go back this way. Can't go that way. Okay. Oh, maybe I can cut down that tree. Maybe I can attack this tree. So, sword. Put the sword on the tangle tree. Like, attack. Give the sword to Nadia. While it is a beautiful sword, I must refuse. I feel that it is your destiny to wield it during the game. I do appreciate the gesture, Doug. Uh-huh. Let's talk to Nadia. Maybe she'll tell me where to do. What do you think we should do? We've got to figure out the secret shortcut the headman mentioned. Surely the fair enough will reveal its location to us. The secret shortcut path out of here. Okay. Give me a light and I'll follow it anywhere. So we need to find the secret shortcut. And maybe we use the sword. Or let's just look. Keep walking. Maybe it'll reveal itself to us. Not it. Don't see anything new. The T. What if I put the cherry bomb on the T? What if I do that? Why do I feel like that might work? I don't know. It might work. Let's try it. Put the cherry bomb on the T. Put the cherry bomb on the T. It disappears in the small red puff. Well, that didn't work. Now we lost our cherry bomb. We gotta go back and get a cherry bomb. Just disappears on touching anything. So I don't understand how it hasn't already disappeared, but okay. And I don't know, should we get another buttercup too? We probably don't need it. Now, can I just go to my map? I'm gonna try this. Right, so picture. And then take a cherry bomb. Take another buttercup. And I got a buttercup with the butter. What was that beep? That beep is, That beep is still here from their previous games. They included the beep. So what if I take this map and I just go, like, here? Oh, okay. No, you can't. You can only go one space at a time. So what's wrong with the game's sound? What's after this game? Well, I want to play Deathgate after this. I want to play all the Legend Adventure games. Or at least a bunch of them. But I might play a different game before that. Also, I'm still playing Resident Evil 5 with Natural Dave when we have times... when we have time. So,
playing through that with Natural Dave. I will play Deathgate, or I will take a break and then play Deathgate. We've got Butter. Butter doesn't last very long. Just melts away. Dude, where do I go? Okay, I went under the recipe. No, the headman mentioned something about a path through regions. The shortcut? Yes, I know of a shortcut to get you quickly past the 5 regions. He waves his wand casually toward the northwest. A path appears amidst the trees. Crap, I just had to ask him about it. But beware, the path runs treacherously close to the void, which must be avoided at all costs. What is this void place? The void is the most dangerous zones within Xanth. All things that enter the void never return. Its boundaries may not be visible, and it may use tricks to trap you within it. What do you think of this sword I got from the villagers? It looks old and pointy. Be careful how you point it at. Okay, bye, Nuff. We're still gonna play Resident Evil 5. Hey, boy, You didn't expect to saunter out of here with my personal mail sticking out of your pocket, did you? How terribly forgetful of me. Just hand over the mail, sonny. Oops. He's mad. Here. Here's your mail. Oh, goody. No doubt more mail from my adoring fans. Thank you, mail boy. Aren't you even gonna read it? No, they're all the same, heaping praise upon praise concerning my magical prowess and the like. But the letter might contain money. Nope, you're wrong. Have a nice day, kid. It didn't contain money. And so we gave that guy his mail, and we got to the next area. The ground beneath your feet gives way easily, becoming increasingly soft and sandy. Turning around, you recognize nothing of where you've been. You seem to be in the midst of a vast expanse of nothingness on all sides. Barren landscape surrounds you on all sides. 5 points. We're in a desert now. We better save the game. Desert. 10. Desert 10. Desert rubble. Look at the rubble. Rubble strewn about. Look at the desert. An expanse of desert. Look at the... Hello?
Uh-oh, so much for good advice from brilliant fairies.
What do you mean?
Haven't you noticed there isn't any way out of this place, Doug?
Come to think of it, I guess you're right.
The void is perhaps the most dangerous place in all of Xanth, and I'm afraid we've blundered into it. Tales have told of people who've managed to escape, but I'm not very hopeful. I'm sorry I haven't been a better companion for you, Tug.
This is where I do my hero thing and get us out of this jam. We gotta figure out how to get out of the void, okay. Butter. Eat the butter. Eat the butter. Swallow what's left of the butter. Sweet. Okay. Are we wearing these? Let's make sure we're wearing the glasses. You're already wearing them. Good. Okay, look at the sword. Put the sword on the sky. The sun. Put the sword on the sky. Like, cut through it. Like, it's not a real sky. Yeah. I can see the door. A door shimmers in and out of view. Hey, did you see that, Nada? Did you see that door?
I have no idea what you're talking about, Doug. A door?
Yes, just concentrate on the air to the north of us.
Okay, I'll give this a shot, but it better be good. When do the festivities begin?
Just keep looking at that area in front of us.
I'm waiting.
Okay, come on. Door, door, go, 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 door, go, go. Sky, look at the sky. Binding starburst dominates the overhead view. Look at the sun. Averted gaze, you eye the blindingly bright desert sun. Plant. Look at the plant. Look at the plant. Delicate plants. Each covered by tiny barbs. There's a door. Get it, Nada. Get it. Get it, Nada. Did you see it?
I can't believe it, but I saw that door you're mumbling about, Doug. I wonder where it leads.
Me too. Maybe it's a way out of here.
Could be. What do you think is making it do that? It's unnerving.
Beats me. I'll keep thinking about it. Did we find the Xanth and gum yet? Nope, but I think that's the final treasure of the game. Touch the plant. You stoop down and touch the plant. A small barb punctures your skin and you quickly withdraw your hand. Fair enough. Pick the plant. A sharp plant covered with sharp barbs. What if I throw the cherry bomb at it? Oh, it doesn't give me a chance to. Do I just have to wait for it? Throw the cherry bomb. I don't want to lose my cherry bomb. I'm going to save it. Save it as Desert 11. Am I in the holodeck? Maybe. We're gonna appear in the simulation from spellcasting. Back in that game again. Let's go, door. I'm gonna throw the cherry bomb at the door. Computer, show door. Exit, computer, exit. Captain, the exit is not appearing. What do we do? Shut up, Data. Worf, pull down Data's pants.
Maybe I need to use the sword on the door. Maybe it just doesn't let me. Every once in a while, the door will just appear after I do something. Smell the buttercup. Eat the buttercup. Eat the cherry bomb. Wait, can you? Yeah, you can't actually do anything while that door is appearing. Okay, Yo, Nada, help. Sure, I saw the door. All this talk about doors bores me, Mundane. Why don't we just wander around and see if there's anything real around here? There's a door. Oh, I can move. But I don't want to move. We have to move. I didn't realize I could move, sorry. What the F? Well, that's when I played Star Trek. A Star Trek game. We were talking about how in Star Trek, Picard could command Worf to pull down Data's pants, and it doesn't matter because he's an android. It would be fine. It wouldn't even be anything wrong with that. Because it's just a rope. It's just like pulling a tarp off of a computer. Data is stronger than Worf, yeah, but Data has to listen to Picard. We'll return to our starting point. We can't take any direction. We keep getting lost. Now, I wonder if we can go back toward Fairy Huff. Fairy Huff. Fairy Nuff. Fairy Nuff. Not Fairy's Huff. We're getting lost every time we try to move, right? Something with the door. Something with the T. Okay, what if I just throw the cherry bomb forward, and it'll throw the cherry bomb at the desert. Disappears. What do we need the cherry bomb for, anyway? Hope I don't need that. Something with the sword? Open the sword. Get your foot in the door? See, you can't click on it when it's appearing, which makes me think I have to do something. Okay, untie the hook, or... No, I think I want to tie it back. Like, throw the hook at the desert. You swing the grappling above your head. No, okay, it didn't work. You have to be holding the desert bear you can put in the grappling. Okay, don't make me. See, it's loading. I can't actually click on that door. Replay Star Trek? I would like to play another Star Trek game. I don't know of another good one to play. That Star Trek The Next Generation adventure game was a lot of fun. The only other game I found that might be good is, Hidden Evil. I could try that. I could also try some of the FMV games, but I don't know how good they are. I haven't found another one where you actually play as the crew of the Next Generation, you know? I would play another adventure game where you play as, like, Picard and Worf and Geordi. But I don't think there are any more games like that. Lieutenant Yar sucks up Data. That's true. That did happen in the first season, but then they neutered Data in one of the cut episodes. They actually neutered his robot dong off. Is there a game with Q? I'm not sure. Then there's Hidden Evil. There's Generations. I couldn't get Generations to work, but I don't think it matters that much because it didn't seem that good. But maybe it is. Crumple the plastic. Crumbling the plastic wrap produces a sound that is somewhat enjoyable. ASMR. Crumple the paper. Brown paper is as crumpled as you can make it. Okay, flatten the paper. Ooh. Rub the paper with... Buttercup. Look at the paper. Let me flatten some paper. Star Trek Borg has Q? Yeah, there's some FMV games. I think that's an FMV one, right? Star Trek Borg, and then there's, Star Trek Klingon. There's, like, Klingon also. They're FMV. I could try those. Who's got an idea? Let's start throwing out ideas here. We're taking ideas. The sword in the desert. The tea in the desert. Tea in the desert. Tea in the plant. Tea in the door. Talk to Donata. Stop appearing and I can't do anything. He is programmed in many forms of sexual pleasure. Yeah, but they neutered his robot dong, Tonda. They took off Data's robot dong. What do you think we should do? Gotta find a way out of here. I mean, I saw the door, Nada. Did you see the door? I think I must have been imagining that door. Why are you getting so a door you can't even point out to me? You saw the door! Talk to Nada. I'm sure I just saw a door. Maybe we have to... Wait, what? You have to believe in the door. If you believe in the door, we can get through it. I'm certain of it. I just saw a door. We can't wander around. Star Trek 25th Anniversary? I could play those old adventure games sometime. I just feel like the space combat section in those isn't the best, right? I used to love those
back when I was a young kid. Now I'm 19, so I'm older. Star Trek TNG Future Past. Oh, but it's like a platformer game. I am stumped. Okay, let's just start trying stuff. Untie the hook. Okay, now tie the rope to the desert. Tie the rope to the plant. I need to somehow, when this door appears, climb the rope. I need to somehow get that door to stay. Like right now. I can't do anything. Go forward. You can't do anything. It just keeps appearing and disappearing. So what can we do to make this door stick? To make it stay? I was thinking I could throw the hook at it and hook the door and open it. Paper. Buttercup. Sword. The sword is a new... You're definitely gonna have the sword. It's an adventure. Okay, I'll look at it. I could play another Star Trek game. Sword on the mesa, sword on the sun, something with the sword. The tea in the desert. The tea in the plant. Tea in the rocks. Look at the rubble. Take the rubble. Talk to the rubble. What is take? Whoa, no, don't do that. Well, no! Take the rubble. Take the desert. It seems more solid, I don't know. I can't touch it. You're right, it keeps appearing more and more, right? Is it appearing more and more, or has it always appeared to that degree? Give the sky to Nadia. I'll give you whatever you want, Nadia. I'll give you the world if I could. There can be no doubt about it, there's a door here. She just keeps talking about how the door talk bothers her. I got 8 points! Maybe we just have to keep talking about it, and then it appears? You're right, Cosmotic, I think you were right. You're right. Quick, talk to Nada now. Nada. Oh. Okay, we just had to keep talking about it. We did it. You guys are right. You guys are right. Let's go into the unknown. Let's enter the unknown. In this world, you just have to believe. You have to believe in things and they become real. Hi, Monstar. Hi, Serva. A small green gem emerges from within the hilt of the sword. I believe we somehow escaped the void, Doug. This feels more like the outskirts of the region of Earth. Wow, that's cool. Playing some organ. Barrow. An expansive desert. I can't see that thing. Okay, let's go in here. Hi, Chaos. Well, you don't need to believe that for it to be true, Chaos. Let's go in, let's knock on the door. You're going to need to get closer. Okay, get closer to it. Nada impatiently shakes her head and beckons you away from the impervious, from the dangerous void. You barely survived. So that takes us back to the void. What if I go this way? Oh, it's the demon lady. The road before you stops at the desert spring. There's lots of desert stuff around here. And make it better. If at any point the music is too loud, please let me know. Come drink from this spring, young man. I'm sure you'll like the taste of its fresh water. Nope. Already know that she's a trickster. Nope. Good God, gamer. Something looks funny about that spring. Funny in what way? It's glistening in an unnatural way. Nonsense, this water is as pure as you'll find anywhere in Xanth. Trust me, drink. Why should I? Because I'm asking you nicely, my beautiful mundane. Don't do it, Doug. That water's incredibly dangerous. Do we drink it? I'm not drinking it. I'm not an idiot. I know that you're evil. Just because you look like that doesn't mean that I should pay attention to you. I'm gonna play a Star Trek game. I didn't know there were any Star Trek games. Other than Hidden Evil. Drink from the spring now, my dear boy. It will rejuvenate you, make you firmer, stronger, and more able to please me. I wanna please you. You're disgusting. You disgust me. Look at the spring. Well, let's see what happens if you drink the spring. Spring 12. Don't stop believing. Let's drink the spring. You take a long draught from the spring, stand up, and look at Metria.
Now that wasn't so hard, was it, my mundane fool? You'll never win the game now. Have your feelings for me changed at all?
Yes, I find you very attractive, though you've just insulted me.
Oh, there are plenty way more insults where that came from. Why don't we play a little game of catch, Dance? Catch me if you can.
Sure. Sounds fun.
Metria tears off across the desert, motioning for you to follow.
Okay.
It is difficult to resist the temptations of a demoness like Metria, but you'll need to do it to proceed further in the game.
I couldn't resist it!
You just die immediately.
That's a bass. That instrument is a bass.
Thanks for the auto host Zetsu Bera, who was last playing Xenonauts on his channel.
And make it better.
I'm not drinking from this. Drink from the spring lest you die of thirst. How do you know it's safe? I think you're trying to lure me to my doom.
Now you're hurting my feelings. What makes you think I try to hurt you?
I don't relate well to women with tails.
It's not a stinger, Doug. It's just an ordinary tail. Don't let it bother you.
We gotta kill her. Kill her with the sword.
No, don't give the sword to her. Use the sword on her. Stab her. She's a demon.
Don't give me junk like this when there are so many more interesting things we could be doing. Stab her with the sword. Go to the barrow door.
Unlimited power.
Sexy girls. They can be the devil sometimes. Anyone can be the devil sometimes. You're not leaving here before I'm done with you, mundane, but I want to go now! I can't even leave? Alright, we've got to kill her before she doesn't even let me leave.
I guess not.
Stab her with the sword. Give her the flower. I'm not drinking from the spring, but I can't even swim.
Drink now or forever hold your peace. What peace?
Give her the flower and get her the hell out of here. Give her the buttercup. Don't give me junk when there's more interesting things we could be doing. Hey, G-Pudding, I gotta figure out how to get away from this lady.
How about put the sword on Metria.
Stab her with it. Let's see. Let's talk to Nada. Maybe Nada will help.
It was an accident, G-Pudding. I was just trying to play an interesting adventure game. But I think that Legend still has their pervy tendencies.
What's with Metria and the spring princess?
She wants you to drink from the love spring. This would cause you to fall helplessly in love with her. You would then be unable to win the game. But she seemed pretty nice.
Looks can be deceiving, Doug. Metria is a demoness. She derives immense pleasure from towing people's lives, leading them astray, that sort of thing.
I don't know what to do, I'm stuck in another spot. I don't know where to go, it's tough to figure it out.
There, the barrow's now open for you, stupid mundane. I hope you and your lizard princess have fun groveling around in the dirt.
So we just had to mess with her a lot? We just had to resist her urges over and over?
Okay, not the best, but fine. Alright, let's go in the barrow now.
Some of the puzzles in this game are a little bit weird.
I open the barrow. It's loading. You force the ancient heavy wooden door open. It reeks its ancient hinges.
There's something weird about this game. Voice. Text. Oh, I can't turn it on.
It's weird. You can turn sound on or you can turn music on. But you can't have them both on.
I can't turn the voice on.
What if I turn sound on?
And turn voice on. No, I don't have voice. For some reason.
What do I think of this game?
I think it's alright. Some of the puzzles, like, where I just click talk over and over, like that last one, they're not the best.
Let's save the game.
Bow, bow, bow.
Black door.
We haven't gotten stuck, so.
They thought people wouldn't be able to resist, and that was the puzzle.
Hinges. Look at the hinges.
Down, down, down. Let's go in. Let's go in the darkness.
Oh, here we go. You're in a dimly lit chamber with an ancient barrow. An echo reverberates through the barrow. Nada is afraid.
Why are you afraid? Okay. No hints. How bizarre. She looks like Heather Locklear. Yeah, I guess so. Oh, it looks like we found a maze. Let's maze this out, guys. And enter. Okay. Alright, we're gonna maze this out. Hey, who turned out the lights? Wait a minute, the lights are still on. Huh. Torch. Look at the dark. Although the torches continue to burn, you are surrounded by an eerie darkness. Nada, where are you? I can't see anything. I'm terribly afraid. Oh my god. Look at the torch. Take the torch. The torch is firmly attached to the barrel wall. What happened? The lights went out. Is that Nada talking? Look at the torch. The torch burns brightly with the seemingly inexhaustible full fuel supply. Okay. I wonder what happened. I couldn't see anything except the torches, but they were burning brightly. Yeah, weird. That was weird. All this activity has gotten me quite thirsty. Let's go back to that spring and get a drink. Wait a minute. You want a drink from the love spring with me? Yes, let's go there right away. It's the girl tricking me again. No, we're not going back there. I don't know where I was. I think I went this way. Nada grabs your arm and drags you out of the barrow? No, I'm not drinking from this. No. They so much switched out with Nada. Don't leave me, Doug. I feel so comfortable by this spring. Let's stay here a while. I think they swapped her out. Drink from the spring, Doug. I was wrong before. This water's completely safe to drink. Nope. But you just told me it was dangerous to drink here, Princess. I can't imagine what I was thinking when I told you that, Doug. Just have a bit of water. You look parched. You said it was dangerous not 5 minutes ago. I thought it was only a momentary lapse, Doug. Why don't you have a drop from the spring with me? No! I'm not drinking from that! I know what you're doing. You're tricking me. What do I think of the game? You already... I answered you already. I said it's alright. It's not bad. It's unique. Please don't leave me, Doug. Hi, Sergnum. Yeah, we've got 3D glasses. It's fine. Don't you feel like joining me in the water, Doug? I think you'd enjoy bathing with me, wouldn't you? I'm not sure. I heard bad things about the spring. I wouldn't pay them any heed. Who told you that, Doug? You did. I did? I have no recollection of that event, young man. Perhaps you're a bit overwhelmed by your journey through Xanth, Doug. Calm yourself down. Everything will be alright. I really think a swim is just what you need right now. I did, deviant fish! Why are they keep sticking me at this spring? And I can't leave. And make it better. And it's loading? Like... I know that you're the fake Nada. What do you think we should do now? Drink from the pool. I'm not drinking from the pool. We're not drinking from the pool. I think this puzzle's really weird. I know you switched out. I could tell that you switched out. Look, she switched out with Lola, or whatever her name is, in the darkness. So you thought through my disguise, you impotent mundane. May you wander through Xanth without aid, foolish boy. You'll never know the wondrous pleasures you would have enjoyed with me. Hey, what'd you do with Nada? That's a good question, Dalt, but just to show you how merciful I am, I'll hand you this little homing device to find her. The higher the number, the closer you'll be to her. If I was really bored, I would quit. I'm not bored. Oh, so they give me a little thing to... But I can't even trust that this will actually find her. It's a red box with a purple button and a gauge with a needle. The switch is off and the needle's pointing to zero. Turn it on, I guess. Turn on the strange contraption. Look at it. It's a red box with purple button. Switch the needle's pointing to zero. Good for it. I want to go back in the barrow. Let me go in the damn barrow. Does this tell me which way to go? Or, see, I don't know if this is the actual way to go or the fake way to go. Red thing, maze, time. Red thing maze time. Hey, mad genius, what's up? Better not run out of battery. Needle is pointing to 5. Whatever. Good for it. Needle is pointing to 4. What do you mean, 4? What does 4 mean? What does that mean? It's a red box with a purple button and a gauge with a needle. Look at it. The switch is on and the needle is pointing to 4. The level, is that the level of closeness that we have? Let's go this way this time. It's a dead end. Oh, I can go south here. Sound like flapping wings is audible nearby. We're getting close to a demon. Okay. This song's pretty good. Then we got a T. Let's keep going south. Go this way. A gust of warm air rushes through the passage. Sounds like someone just farted. So this is a dead end. It's a dead end. Flopping wings nearby here. Oh, I should probably look at the, I should look at the thing here. She literally told me? What do you mean? I was paying attention. So needle is pointing to 6. But I didn't trust her. She's not trustable. Needle is pointing to a 7. She said it would help me find her, but I don't trust her, so I was ignoring her. When I go up, it's lower. So it makes me think she's back on the other side. So let's go back to the other side. What did she say? Not that I trust it. Let's try going to the other side. Four. Who cares if I was paying attention or not? Anyway. People don't visit this stream to see someone pay attention. They visit the stream to see the God Gamer Puzzwiz play games. Play gamings. I don't know where we are. Hold on. This is not what my thing looks like. Okay, wait. I know where I am. Okay. Let's look at this. Anybody that's here to see someone to watch me pay attention, put your hand up. Okay, so this is a... I don't see any hands. Okay, this is another T. Let's look at this thing. I do not see a single hand. Yeah, but I just told you, I didn't pay attention because she's evil. She's an evil person. And she tries to trick you. So it would have just filled your mind with useless knowledge if you actually listened to what she said. Okay, so this goes, the needle's pointing to 5. And back at the T again. And then back at the other T, and then go up. Dead end. Dead end of a maze. The dead end's pointing to a 3. We're far away over here. We're really far away. Izzy's has your hand up, but don't... Amberzine has her hand... Oh, so a couple people have hands on. So you guys actually do want someone that pays attention? Okay, I'll note that in my feedback booklet. A footfall like that of rodents is barely audible. How much does a submarine cost? Probably like millions of dollars. Mazing it up
for you.
Mazing it up for me and you. Hey, here we go. A switch is in the northern wall. Needle is pointing to 1. Maybe we wanted 1. You flip the switch and another switch appears. Okay, flip the other switch. Okay, keep flipping the switches. Hey, Bangwashy. Nice one. Does my feedback book like have things I don't give a shit about? On the cover? No, it actually doesn't exist. I wrote that down on a piece of paper and then I burned it. This is funny. We just keep pushing switches in here? Okay. You have to figure out what the next switch that appeared was. Keep flipping them up. Okay, we're just gonna keep flipping these. Hopefully this isn't a troll. This could be a troll. But it's a 1, and maybe 1 is what we needed. Let's keep switching them. Maybe we just have to fill in... Okay, that looks like all the switches. Now what? You're standing in the dimly lit chamber, a single archway opens on the southern wall, a bunch of metal switches lie on the northern wall. I flip them all, do we flip them back? No, don't do that. Stop. Put the switch down? Maybe we have to turn them all off? Turns into a flat metal plate. Okay, so now I flip them all back? God damn. I wouldn't put that past this game. It seems so very trolly. And I wonder if that's, if this actually happens in the book, too. The book is trolly, like the book series is trolly. Has anyone ever, read the Xanth books? Just switch them all down. I mean, they seem kind of goofy. Oh, I wouldn't be surprised if they're... this is something that happens. But it also seems just kind of like something that you do in an adventure game. Okay, flip them all down. Puzzwiz. Strange plates melt into the wall and a large glowing button takes their place. Okay. Wait. The barrel wall begins to vibrate. The wall of the barrel opens up, revealing a descending staircase. Okay. I did it. That was so trolly. New door. 14. Nope. Oh, I found her. Found my girl. You're in a foul-smelling dungeon, not a Naga's chain to the dungeon wall. Don't look at me in this state, Doug. How come? That foul demon has trapped me in this horrible place, and my attempts to free myself from these chains have exhausted myself, ending up stuck in my Naga form in less than the princessly position. But you're beautiful! You looked, you impudent young man. I specifically told you not to. So what's the big deal about a little peek? That's it. I'm done playing this stupid game. Demons, do you hear me, Wraiths? You can find another companion for this irreverent mundane. I quit. Oops. Screwed up. Kinda screwed up. You're not supposed to be all pervy on- you're not supposed to perv out on her. Let's restore the game. You're not supposed to perv out on that Naga lady. He uses British humor? Oh. I'm not really into British humor. I'll still get one of the books and try it someday. That's why the game is like this, Paranoid? Or, well, it's British humor? Okay, that could be bad. British humor's pretty trolly and strange. The meter was sort of useful. It took us to where it got to one, but we just had to map out the map. All right, my eyes are sealed. What happened? That foul demon has trapped me in this horrible place, and my attempts to free myself from these chains have exhausted myself, ending up stuck in my Naga form in less than a princessly position. I'll be right back.
I gotta be back.
Retrobrag about today. Already showed the box. Already retrobrag today. No Tom tips. Tom tips are a natural thing. I don't prepare a Tom tip every day like I used to. You just, if a Tom tip comes up, we do a Tom tip, but it has to be a natural Tom tip. Yeah, that's true. I have to go take a cold shower. I can't handle this. You look hurt. Are you okay? You looked, you impudent young man, I told you not to. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it, please forgive me. That's it. Oh, shit. We can't look at her or else we lose the game. Alright, I'm gonna restore. Brown, 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 brown. Frosted Tom tips. Hmm. Okay, the Naga's chained to the wall. Our eyes are sealed, what happened? She trapped her in the horrible place, and I couldn't free myself, and I'm in a Naga form. Okay. Without looking, I can't do much to help you. Just do as you're told and remember not to look at me. Okay. Okay, what do you wish?
Check out the manacles binding my wrists. I'm sure there's an easy way to uncuff them. Metro had me locked up in a second. And remember, don't even think of looking at me.
Okay, I'll check out the manacles. Yeah, I'll check out the manacles. We can't look at her, because we're in deep shit. Save us new door. Save us new door. Okay, take the dress. Wear the dress. Nada's dress is about 29 sizes too big for you. Okay, put the dress on Nadia. Give the dress to Nadia. The pink dress isn't yours to give. Hey, mundane dunce, you hear from the vicinity of one of Nada's arms? Something with these manacles. Look at the manacles. Medical manacles clamped around Nada's wrists are attached with chains to fixtures on the dungeon wall. Sword? Put the sword on the manacles? Try to think of a way putting the sword on the manacles would fail utterly. Hey, over here, you hear from the vicinity of one of Nada's arms. What do? I look at her arm? From one of her arms? What are you talking about? One of her arms. Agony moss. Take the agony moss. You're gonna need something to put the moss in. It's extremely caustic. Put it in this buttercup. Buttercup just wouldn't look right in the agony moss. Hey, over here, you hear from the vicinity of one of Nada's arms. What? In her armpit? What am I looking for here? In the vicinity of one of her arms? What? Am I supposed to talk to the manacles? Talk to a manacle. You politely ask the manacles to let Nada go. Oh, alright, the irritated but polite manacles respond. Here you go.
Turn away for a moment while I get dressed, Doug.
Okay, I'm looking away.
Too late, I'm already dressed. You freed me and protected my honor, Doug. My respect for you has increased a notch. You seem to be a generally good mundane. I will continue to try to assist you in your quest for the prize.
Okay, so now I understand. This game is a British humor game. So, okay. Now I'm back on. Now I can at least understand how to get through this. It means we have to just do things that are completely illogical and dumb. Hi, Stefan. In case you can't tell, I don't really like British humor anymore. Not that much. I will continue to try to assist you in your quest for the prize.
Okay, thanks. Yes, please. I really want to get at that prize. Now that I'm free, there's a chance of claiming the prize. Let's get busy.
We're figuring things out. We have to do things that don't make any sense, so it's kind of like Discworld. So, I don't know how to get the Agony Moss. We just leave now? We're supposed to leave? Okay, the door went back up. Alright. Now I'm wondering when the game's gonna troll me and tell me I forgot to pick up a banana or something. Okay, so that's where Nadia, that's where Nada is. But I don't know if we're trying to get to another area in here. You know? It's not that I don't like British people, it's just that certain types of British humor, I'm not always appreciative of, I don't always like, but it's fine. It's not like I hate British people. Just like saying I don't like, you know, potatoes. You know? Doesn't mean if you like potatoes that I hate you. But, like Discworld, if you try to play Discworld without hints, that game will drive you nuts because it's just so obscure and sort of British-y, if anyone knows what I mean. Touch the plaque. Running your fingers over the stone plaque, the only thing you're able to spell out is the word Mac. Okay. Take the plaque. Take the plaque. Hey, Tam, what's up? Do not hate the British. Mac plaque. Mac plaque. Now I think I have to talk to every little thing. Talk to the plaque. Exactly, plaque, don't talk back. You let the stone plaque. I don't know what to do with this plaque, but I marked down where it is. Let's map out the rest of this. I do like potatoes, though. That's the thing. I actually do like potatoes. In all the forms. You don't think it's the same? I think it is kind of the same. Okay. It's like, I don't really like, it's like saying I don't really like, that guy that goes, get her done, okay? It's like saying I don't like that guy's jokes. And actually, that guy is actually pretty funny. I'm trying to think of a comedian I don't like. Oh, taking another path down here. There should be a dead end right here. Yeah, it is. Okay. Well, there's nothing here. Another dead end down here. Throwing you mixed signals? My bad. Screw everyone! Crap, there's more paths here, what? Yes, okay, that's- yes, because I know where we are. Let's go north. The other dead end? There's a hole here, a pad. Get on the pad, I'm scared to go on the pad. Pad. Pad 15. Pad 15. Pad. Get on the freaking pad. Get on the freaking pad! I'm not anti-potato! You step on the metallic pad, feel an electrical jolt, and find yourself in another barrow chamber. Nice! Okay. Sort of nice. I got points for it. Okay, now... I don't know where we are. Now I'm lost, but luckily there's only one way to go. And we found a door. Stands ajar. When is a door not a door, guys? I have a question. Open the door ajar. Carefully inspecting the door ajar, you fail to find a sufficient handhold? Held? Look at the door ajar. The door is ajar. Is this not- I'm not actually supposed to go through this? Let's talk to Nada about this door ajar. This game's getting way too British. What do you think we should do now? The door ajar seems pretty odd. I wonder if there's a way for us to take it out. What do you mean by take it out? I mean get rid of it, of course. I bet there's a way out through that door. She puts the lotion in its basket. Dane Cook. I used to like Dane Cook, but then I became a non-Dane Cook fan. Throw the hook at the door ajar. That didn't work. That didn't work. The door is ajar. When it's a foot, nice. The door is ajar. Talk to the door ajar? Door ajar. Open the door. Close the door ajar? You kick the door, but it remains ajar. Open the door ajar. Put the sword on the door ajar. Look, close, take. You're standing in a dimly lit chamber. A single archway opens on the southern wall. A door stands ajar before you. Okay, so if it's a door ajar, it's ajar, right? So I've got to open the jar, right? Like a lid. Did I look at the game box cover? Yeah, it's right above my head. I've got to open the jar. I've got to break the jar. But I don't have any commands for it. Take the door ajar? You reach out to take the door. When your fingers touch its wooden surface, the door disappears. A small empty jar appears on the floor. Okay, so take worked.
I get it, Doug. The door wasn't only ajar, it was actually a jar.
Yeah, I get it. It's the dumbest thing I've seen around here. I like how the main character is actually... Now, has my own thoughts within him. Ironwood tree. Look at the ironwood tree. I like this game. I like this game. I am having fun with this game. Don't get me wrong. A massive ironwood tree blocks the entrance to the room to the north. I think playing Discworld just soured me on British humor, that's all. Alright, climb the ironwood tree. There isn't any place on the ironwood tree to get an adequate foothold. Look at the jar? It's an empty jar. What do I do with this tree? Take the tree? Even a seasoned bodybuilder would have difficulty budging this massive tree. Open the tree? Talk to the tree? No. Put the ironwood tree on the sword? Put the sword on the ironwood tree? You can't figure out a way to get the sword onto the ironwood tree. Put the tea on the tree? Hook on the tree? The jar on the tree? Open the jar? You open the empty jar and gaze around inside it for a moment. Pick up the door, you were right. It made sense, because the game's goofy now. When is a door not a door, when it's a window? That's true, you could use a window as a door. You absolutely could do that, Morpheus. Don't let anybody tell you you can't use a window as a door. Bill Cosby, Carlos Vinci, I don't know. The whole Bill Cosby becoming a raper was... Kind of throws you off on enjoying his humor now. Ironwood tree. Cool. That's great. Am I supposed to do something with this tree now? I've gotta, give the tree to Nadia. Let's talk to Nadia. Hug the tree, take the tree. What do you think we should do? Now that we've got the jar, perhaps we can collect some of that agony moss from the dungeon. What can I use that for? Maybe you'd better read up on agony moss. It's one of the most caustic substances in Xanth, able to eat through anything. Okay. So we have to go back and get that moss, but I thought the door closed. I know how to get there. Maybe there's moss I can get somewhere else? Mm-hmm. I'm lost. I'm not lost, I vaguely know where I am. Maybe we can get moss somewhere else. I vaguely know where I am in relation to shit in this maze. Okay, here we go. Your dimly lit chamber with an ancient barrow. Stone mortar lies on the barrow floor. Take the mortar. Oh, we got a mortar now. Okay. God, you gotta hit every spot in this maze or else you're screwed. Luckily, these are singular paths here. It is a snake lady. Yes, she's in my party, Anshti. She's my advisor. Nice, Tonda. Nice. Okay. This is a single path. In a dimly lit wait, are we stuck on a single path now? This takes me back to the tree area with the metallic pad. Oh, maybe I have to stand on the pad? It blocked off the paths back here? Maybe. Let's see. Let's get on the pad again. Okay. So it teleported us. That's a teleporter. That's why I was confused about what was happening there. Alright, let's go try to get more moss. Good thing I wasn't mapping it out. Good thing I wasn't mapping that out on that second world where we teleported. Alright, now we've got a mirror over here. Look in the mirror. Step closer to the mirror and study it closely. In a moment, another explicable image is revealed to you. You see a girl who looks like a bit like Kim floating on a raft. Oh, great. We're gonna see the stupid Kim doing her dumb adventures. Does Kim ask you as many questions as she asks me, Jenny? She's just curious, Cyrus. It's a sign of intelligence. But shh, look, she's starting to daydream. They hate Kim. This part of the river always makes us mermen sad, Jenny. Did you know that these bubbles are filled with things that people have thrown away or abandoned? You mean someone has abandoned that poor dog? What's gonna happen to him? There's no return from the river of forgetfulness. I'm afraid that dog is doomed. Isn't there anything we can do about it? It's Kim's daydream, Jenny. She's the only person who can take action. All we can do is watch. Oh, Kim got herself a dog. Look, Cyrus, she broke the bubble and saved the dog. Hooray. The boating accident. She is an exceptional girl, Jenny. Not only is she smart, but she's compassionate, too. You must have enjoyed being her companion. Well, take good care of her, Jenny. I'd hate to see her disappointed if she doesn't win the prize. Don't worry, we're still ahead. Doug is catching up. It'll never make it to Humphrey's Castle ahead of us. Stupid gym teacher, Kim. Well, at least Kim hasn't progressed with much past the Water Wing. I recognize that as the Withacookie River, not that far from here. You mean I still have a fighting chance? Most definitely. She's only a hair ahead of you if this race is going to take us as far as they think. I'm actually kind of starting to like this game more. Now that I understand the motivations behind it. Okay, so that's the mirror. Now I understand what's going on with this game. And this is the maze section. So once we get through the maze section, we won't have to deal with any other mazes again. So that's good. We're getting through the maze section. So that's a happy little thing, Jenny. I know where we are. Don't worry, guys. I know exactly where we are. No, I don't. Yes, I do? Yes, I sort of do. Now, from over here, I should be able to go south. Why can't I? Don't worry, I know where we are. I have a vague idea. And all we need is a vague idea. We need to go back to that dumb moss. Okay, I know where we are. Dead end. Good. Perfect. Maybe there's some... Can I go back in the door? Mark plaque. The mark plaque? This is where the plaque is with Mark. I don't know what the deal is with this. Let me look in this. A stone plaque hangs from a rusty nail. There are some indentations on its surface. Look at the mortar. Shallow stone mortar contains nothing. Can I take this? I can't take this, right? Hey, Game Life Game. Thanks for the host. You probably pulled the pack from the wall, but it's immensely heavy. Can you do it, Nada? Can you take it? No, she can't take it. Hey, the coup. Sup? I want to beat this game. I mean, I haven't really been stuck at any point, which is nice. Let me go this way, actually. Oh, that's a dead end. So there's a plaque here. I don't know what to do with the plaque. I got so much tartar, I don't have to dip my fish sticks in shit. Okay. So we haven't looked over here yet. I'm a little bit worried that there's a whole lot more of this to go through. I'm a lot of bit worried about that, actually. But my map is looking pretty good right now. I've got a good solid map. And this will take me back to a four-way. Yeah, okay. It took us to a four-way. Hey, Dave. Welcome back. Do you like pizza, Dave? I'm in a maze, Dave. I'm in the maze section of the game, and we're mapping it out perfectly with 100% accuracy. Yeah, I mean, I like pizza in the morning. I don't know about you guys, but I do. I like it in the evening. I like it every day. I like it anyway. Okay, now my map is getting real shitty. Okay, this is a dead end, luckily. A drop of water winds down a wall. Good. I hope I don't have to read those. This side of the maze is big, guys. Flapping wings is audible nearby, but these are dead ends, so that's good. Also, hi, Anchty. If I didn't say hi, hi. Welcome to RetrogradeTom.com/Twitch. So we have to finish searching this side. I should probably just go get the moss and stop messing around over here. This is the part that we searched before. Was this a dead end? No, this is another T. I just want to search this whole maze so I know what's happening here. We go down from here. Pizza can be on a bagel. Pizza can be on a bagel and eat it anytime. Pizza can be on anything and eat it anytime, though. It doesn't have to just be on a bagel to eat it anytime. You can always eat it anytime. And that's the problem I have with that advertisement, because it's false. Well, I mean, it's true, but it's not, it doesn't tell you all the information you need to know about pizza. God damn, this maze is big. Pizza in the summertime is great. Pizza anytime is good, though, Paranoid. Anytime pizza. Does the map not show this? What map? Shit. Shit all over everything in the world. There's a freaking map right here, Tom. You fool. You remember? You see this big button over here that says map? Why don't you try just clicking that stupid button? Instead of drawing your own dumb map in a game that has a map. You ever think of that? Thanks, Cosmotic, for keeping the stream on track. We need good helpers like you to just help things along, because I got caught up in talking about British humor and the conversation about British humor and potatoes, and I didn't realize that there is a map button, and it tells you that there's a map button right there. Could have just been using that, and that would have been a lot easier. But. Wow, this part's bigger. This part's pretty big. The game's driving me a little crazy. Hey, with intent. That's all. The game's just driving me a little crazy. Ooh, what do we get? Pestle. Oh, we got a mortar and a pestle. We can grind up some stuff. Some pizza in the morning. Can it have mozzarella and anchovy? It can. It can also have salami, extra cheese, and origami. Whatever you want. Deviant fish. Bagels are disgusting. How? You think bread's disgusting? How is a bagel disgusting, Tam? Please explain. I'm confused. Do you not like bread? Maybe you've had bad bagels.
Dude, I'm an old school gamer, but I'm only 19, so I'm not used to all these old school, you know, techniques. That's all. That's all it is. There we go. We can even navigate using the map. But I just wanted to draw, you know, map. I wanted to be a little old school about it today. That's fine. Some of you casual gamers might like to use maps. I don't always like using the in-game mapping function. Sometimes I like to do it myself. I just find that to be fun, and that's what I was doing. Origami? Yes, origami. I like pizza with origami. Thanks, DeviantFish. You're number one on my list of viewers. Yeah, I'm into artisanal mapping, exactly. Thank you, Fellaheen, for pointing out the reality of the situation. I gotta come up with those excuses right away after I do something dumb. That's all I have to do. Instead of admitting, see, my tendency is to be honest, because I'm an honest guy. I have a tendency to be honest and say, well, yeah, I'm really a complete moron, and that's why I wasn't using the map function, but what I gotta do is start coming up with excuses, with bullshit excuses, and then maybe I can look cooler, you know? Okay, here's another dead end. Yeah, so coming up on my stream, retrogradetom.com stream, more bullshit excuses. Look forward to it. Okay, so this is where the door was. Let's see, and hit the button, and we can just go right back down and get the moss. Okay, at least we explored the whole thing, and we got the mortar and the pestle. We actually needed to do that. You have bagel rage. Yeah, it's a pretty big place, but at least we have this map. Bangwashy. Alright. Get this shit. Get this goddamn moss. Alright, we got the moss. 7 points. Now, do I have to put this in the mortar? No. Okay. So we just... For some reason, the jar can hold the moss, but nothing else can. Okay. Let's go back to that ironwood tree and put the moss on the ironwood tree. Why is Naga afraid? Nada afraid? What happened to her down there? The dough was boiled and baked? Well, yeah, you can also have Montreal-style bagels, which are... Wait, I think that is Montreal-style bagels, when they're boiled. Or they're, like, oven... They're like, what's it called? Brick oven. Wood-fired oven bagels are... That's Montreal-style of bagel. Went the wrong way. Do-do-do-do. We gotta go this way. But there's that plaque on the wall. I don't know what to do with it. Let's try using this moss on the plaque. Let's save it. There's New York-style bagels, and then there's Montreal-style bagels. I really like bagels. That's why I'm such a chubby bitch. That's what my wife says. Plaque. 16. Bagels are part of the reason why I'm chubby. Put the Manganiellus on the plaque. Now, there wouldn't be any pun in that. I'm wondering what this is for, and I don't know what that's for. More bullshit excuses. Get used to it. Pestle. Pestle? Pestle. It says pestle. It's called a pestle. What is it? Is it pronounced differently? A pestle. How do you guys pronounce pestle? I don't even think I did anything wrong there. Pineapple, raisin, and cream cheese bagels. That could be good. I mean, the pineapple confuses me, but I like the raisin. Get on the pad. Okay. Go over to the barnwood tree. I feel like this game is going smoothly, even though it's a maze section. There we go. You empty the contents of the jar into the ironwood tree. Nothing happens at first, but you hear a sizzling and crackling sound. The massive tree is gradually eaten away, and the cost of mess. When it's completely gone, only residual slime remains. Alright, get the slime in the mortar. No. Take the slime. I want the slime. No. Okay, so don't touch the slime, just go through the door. We're done with the maze. We finished the maze section of the game. We don't have to deal with maze anymore. It rhymes with wrestle? Wrestle? Pestle? Pestle. Wrestle. Pestle? Pestle? I don't think that's right. Pestle? Wrestle. Pestle? I've never heard that before.
Doug, I think we must have moved beyond the region of fire. This area feels more like the region of fire. We moved beyond the region of earth. First void, then earth, now fire. This is really weird. Not really, Doug. That's the order I expect to find them in, heading south toward the gap.
What gap?
A gigantic chasm divides northern and southern Xanth. We're on the northern side of this chasm, which we call the gap. Humphrey's castle lies on the southern side of the gap. How many more regions are there before we get to the chasm, Nada?
Well, let's see. The next one would be water, and the next, and the one after that is air. And I guess that's the last one.
Well, that's our companion with intent. This is the Naga girl. Her powers, she can turn into a human.
5 points. You're walking down a log tubular tunnel. An impressive heat emanating from the end of the tunnel distorts your view. Not a smooth surgown.
Okay, fire hot. Fire hot tunnel. Alright. What was that? What was going on there?
Fiery butthole. It's a fiery butthole here. Tunnel end. Go to the tunnel end. Okay.
That's where we were before. Ginger? I think she's blonde. I can't tell. She might be like dirty British blonde. Blood blonde. Pointy rock.
Sad music now.
Okay, let's keep on moving. There's lava here. I didn't see anything. To make sure I don't miss like any buttercups or anything. Standing precariously upon one of the rocks in the lava lake, a molten dog emerges from the lava lake. A molten man emerges from the lava lake. I think this is okay. Hot dog and a fireman? Alright, let's talk to the fireman.
The dog snarls angrily at you as you turn toward the fireman. You step back in fear of the molten hound.
This is that guy that's on the back of the box.
This guy. This guy right here. So he must be special. You step back in fear of the molten hound. Okay. Let's talk to the hot dog. The dog lowers its head and growls menacingly at you. Can I talk to this guy, or what's the deal? The dog snarls angrily at you. Let's throw the hook at the fireman. Let's give him a hook. No, he doesn't like that. Let's give the sword to the fireman. The dog snarls. Okay. Give the sword to the hot dog. The molten hound barks loudly at you, baring its teeth. Oh, he doesn't like it. I better save the game before we die. Hot dog. 17. The dog is mad. He's naked, yeah. If you look right here, you can see what might be his genitalia, if you're into that sort of thing. I'm not into looking at his genitalia, but maybe other people might be, and I want to make sure that they enjoy the stream as much as they possibly can. Okay, so there's a hot man here, there's a hot man over there, and this was the opening that I went through to get there? Okay, well, what about, can I go into this hole? It seemed like, are these the same holes? There was do you remember the artist who did those paintings? He made all his paints with the same lady, it was his wife, and then he disappeared. Oh, lava penis. It might be. I think if you look closely, get your face real close up to the screen, you might be able to see one, Wit's End. Get in on that. The opening in the side of the pointy rock must have been caused by something falling from above. There's nothing inside it. I have no clue what to do with this dog. Look at the hot dog. It's the hottest dog you've ever laid eyes on. You feel a little hungry and you're a little afraid that he is too. Look at the fireman. The man is made completely out of molten lava. He seems to have a small drinking problem. Look at the lava. You gaze in horror at the lake of molten rock. Now then, a bubble slowly forms and bursts. I don't get the mortar in the lava. Pestle. I think it's a pestle. Hey, Rhombus. Yeah, it might be a male stripper. Maybe we dance with him? The thing is, you can't do anything other than these commands. Take the hot dog. Can take the hot dog. Put the lava in the mortar. Put the lava in the jar. Put the jar in the lava. Fill the jar with the lava. We can't get lava. We can only get moss or small insects. Put the sword. Give the sword to the... They don't want the sword. So the dog snarls at me. I gotta give something to this dang dog or else he won't go away. He barks. He's mad when I give him the flower. Give him this paper. He's mad. Can I talk to... I can't. I don't think there's any point in going back. There's this opening. What about with this opening? The opening in the buttercup. Put the buttercup in the opening. Why burn the buttercup? I'm burning something. Put the sword in the opening? I'm burning. I don't really have anything to burn. Burn this paper? Burn the paper. Burn the plastic? I'll get mad at that. Plastic fumes. Put the hook in the opening? Okay, let's untie this. Put the rope in the opening. Put the hook in the opening. Put the pestle in the opening. Fireman is thirsty? Oh! You carefully place the mortar inside the pointy rock, it glows a hot red. Okay. Put the pestle in it now. Okay, what am I doing here? Put the sword in there now? The sword in the mortar? What is the reason for this? So the mortar is now hot. Take it, but it's really hot. It's a natural oven and you set it gently on the ground. Alright. It cools and you pick it up. I need to put something in this and then heat it up? Like a dog food. What would this dog want to eat? I don't have anything this dog can eat. Hope it's not something to do with that plaque. What would a dog want to eat? Dog food or meat? I think we leave and we gotta go find some meat. Let's talk to the, rat. Crap, this freaking maze. We explored everywhere in this maze, though. You look uncomfortable, Nada. What's the problem? It's so hot in here, I feel I'm about to expire. Why don't you put your hair up in a bun? Really? What makes you say that? Because buns are really cool. Are you really sure you want my hair up in a bun? Maybe? Okay, maybe later. What? We can make her put her hair up in a bun? Mix and bake something, yeah. Yeah. But I don't have anything I can mix. Flour? You look uncomfortable. Alright. Yeah, buns are really cool. Yes, I want you to put your hair up in a bun. If you insist, you're really gonna owe me for this one, Doug Mundane. Here you go. Nadia puts her hair up in a bun and hands it to you for safekeeping. Ah, it's a bun! We got a bun in this game, man. I can't believe that. We had to talk to her and get a bun. So now we got a bun for the hot dog. Holy crap. I did not expect this game to be... What did I do? Okay, we fixed it. Okay, so now I'm assuming we use the bun on the hot dog somehow. Yeah, hot dog bun. The bun for the hot dog. It's like sometimes this game is kind of logical and then other times it's completely ridiculous. I mean, it's not really hard to figure out what to do, though. You just have to talk to her from time to time and see if she has, a new thing to say. I'll just save it under Hot Dog 17. Alright, give the bun to the hot dog. The molten hound barks loudly at you, baring its teeth. Alright. So that wasn't it. Give the bun to the fireman? Eat? Smell? The dog? It's a bun. Put the bun in the mortar? Do I have to bake it? Let's look at the bun. Look at the bun. It's a hot dog bun. This is a hot dog. Put the bun in the lava? Throwing the bun in the lava will be the end of it. Put the mortar in the opening. Put the bun in the mortar. Smell bun. Smells like a hot dog bun. It's a hot dog. I give it to him and he's mad. Put the bun on the hot... Okay. Hold on, this might work because this game's... Put the hot dog on the bun? No, hot dog can't be taken. Put the bun on the hot dog? He's barking at me. Did he know how dumb this game is? I'm not sure. Take the hot dog. Play Monkey Island? Oh boy, oh boy. I probably have to go soon, guys. Well, okay, what if we, like, put it in paper? Okay, I'm clicking the wrong thing. Put the paper on bun. Put a brown paper on a bun. Put the bun on the paper. Bun on the sword. Bun. It's an oven. It's an oven. Open the bun? Maybe. Yeah, maybe. That might be it. I might need to open the bun. Open the bun. Nothing can be permanently open as the hot dog bun. Oven? Put the bun in the opening. It smells like a hot dog bun. I can eat it, but I feel like that's a bad idea. Eat it. Hot dog buns are very dangerous. You wouldn't want to risk it. Yeah, so I might have to go soon. So start planning out your day. I really just want to figure this out, though. We got the bun. Let's try talking to Nadia again. See if she says has anything to say about this. What do you think we should do now? A hot dog would be afraid of a bun if it really looked like you were going to use it. A loaded hot dog bun. Okay. We gotta convince the hound that we mean business about the bun. Talk to the bun. Look at the bun. You're picking your way carefully through the few large stones above the lava current. A path leads uphill. Oh, that's just look. A weird fireman and an equally strange dog have risen from the pool. We gotta use this bun in some way. Put the bun on the hook? Like, oh, I see. I think I have to mix these and put the bun on the hook like a fishing hook. No. Not it. Put the hook on the bun. Put the bun on the plastic? I gotta wield the bun. Oh, close the bun. Put the bun, like a hot bun, put the bun in the mortar. The mortar in the opening. Put the bun on the mortar. Put the bun in the lava. I gotta wield this bun. How do we make this bun dangerous? Put the bun on in the jar. Pickles and ketchup on the bun? Like, get it ready? Put the butter on the bun? Put the buttercup on the bun? Put buttercup on a bun. Put the tea on the bun. Put the sword on the bun? Put the bun on the sword? Put the bun on the dog. Okay. Put the bun on the dog. On the hot dog. He just barks. Missing objects, yes, but you can't bring the mustard through here. You can't bring the mustard to this world, so I don't think it's that. Put the bun, close the bun, look at the bun. Put the bun, smell the bun, eat the bun, eat the bun. Talk to the bun. Open the bun. Put the bun on, untie. Throw the hook at the dog. Swing the grappling hook, doesn't work. I feel like if I could just put it on here like a fishing hook. And there's this oven thing happening at the same time that I don't understand what to do with. The bun, mortar, take the mortar back. It could be more repetition, maybe. You do need the mustard, but you can't even take the mustard. I think that's a troll. I think that's a joke. That's gotta be a joke, because you can't actually pick up the mustard. Troll, because you don't want to see any more of this game. Not a joke. I'm looking it up. Looking it up. Companions of Xanth. Back. Companions of Xanth. Now we gotta look it up. But you can't take the mustard. Bun. You give it the bun, then open mustard. Wait, you can't take the mustard. I knew it was something to do with that mustard, but I never took the mustard. So we're dead-ended right now. And I didn't take the tea bag either. Then open the mustard. Oh. I tried to take the mustard, it didn't work. I could have sworn I tried to take the mustard. It didn't work. But
I'm done streaming for the day, but I'm not done streaming this game, because what I'm going to do is off stream, I'm going to get back to that point, maybe, or I'll just play another game tomorrow on the stream. Thanks for watching today. I'll either get to that point, maybe I'll try to get the CD version, play that version for tomorrow. But we're done for the day. It was a good, solid stream. I have to go anyway. I've got other stuff to do. I've got to go paint some more. I've got other things to do. Thank you for watching today. Hope you guys have a good day. I'm going to find someone to host real quick. It's over, Car. Welcome. It's over. We didn't have the mustard that we needed. We got dead-ended because we didn't pick up the mustard. I could have sworn I couldn't pick up that mustard. Apparently, we can pick it up. And we also need a tea bag. That's what I briefly saw. And I'm wondering what else I missed now. It's a dead-ender game. So we'll see. We'll be back. Probably tomorrow, the new game, and I'm gonna host somebody. Person, that somebody is gonna be. I'm just gonna host Goatee because there's a retro marathon going on right there.